me again. I'm back, motherfucker. The Michael fucking Jordan of this fucking shit, of the whole Bodega Boys fucking universe, nigga. You know who it is. It's Yesenia, motherfucker. And I'm here to announce a very special announcement. Starting from today, y'all niggas is not getting no more free content. I've been giving y'all niggas free content for 180 motherfucking episodes, stupid. Okay? So now, y'all niggas is gonna have to sign up to my OnlyFans, all right? Okay, it's Yesenia Lahadi, you know what I'm saying, 180, you know what I'm saying, because that's my block, you know what I'm saying. So if you see me on full wash with my cheeks out, you know what I'm saying, do not record you with your own device, okay, because that's my premium content. Also, I have a premium Snapchat that you could join for just $5 right now, you know what I'm saying. You could watch me take a shower, you could watch me put my scrubs on in the morning and shit like that, you know what I'm saying. So that's all I'm saying. So yo, no more free Randy, you know what I'm saying. I'm gonna tell y'all niggas that one last time, you're gonna hear this beautiful, gorgeous phlebotomy voice on your fucking earlobes, nigga, okay. This is the Bodega Boys Podcast, episode 180, stupid, alright. Shout out to 184 Watch, that's my niggas over there. All right, do the fucking drop for the last time. If you want to hear me say, do the drop in mad different voices and shit like that with my tetas out, hit my OnlyFans. OnlyFans/Yesenia180SexyBami. Let's go. Do the drop, nigga.
Episode 180.
Yo, you said you're fed up.
Yo, fam, I was about to sign up. Like, that's just going to be mad awkward. Like, it's going to be like, you said $35 to the kid Mero. I was like, shit. Decline.
Niggas like, in the notes, nigga puts scrubs vid.
Scrubs plus climax. Episode 180 of the World's Most Dangerous Podcast. I am DJ Nice, the Kid Mero. Together we are the who?
Bodega Boys.
That's right, 180 episodes of this bullshit.
God
nigga.
Damn.
Just getting better with time.
Yo, word God. Word God. 180 God.
180.
You know
yo, open your third eye. You open that mean? Peripheral grant. Word Let God. Me ask you something.
Kick it,
Let
brother.
Me preach something, all right? The Knicks play at where?
Speak
Master
King.
Square Garden. Master Square Garden.
Teach
Master
them.
Square Garden. What's the short name for Master Square Garden?
MSG.
MSG is in what? Chinese food.
Boom.
Chinese food is in black communities.
That's
it leads
right.
to high blood rates.
That's
AKA
right.
James Dolan
Teach
is killing black
devils.
People.
Teach uh-huh. these devils. Uh-huh.
What you was know General Tuso? General Tuso was a great veteran.
That's right.
In the Civil War.
That's right, man.
And he fought
you know
for
I mean?
Black freedom.
They don't understand he was one of the original Tuskegee Airmen. Y'all disrespect
That's
him.
Right. That's right. Remember you know in saying? Africa, we could fly when white people were petting dogs.
Yeah, that's right. In caves.
Hip hop, hip hop, real hip hop.
You know what I'm saying? Ah.
That's always responsible by Cash App. Yo, shout out to Showtime.
It's Showtime.
One, a very illustrious late night show just had a successful season finale
yeah.
and has been picked up for another season.
Well, yeah.
Shout
shit.
Out to DJ Mero. That's right. Showtime, DJ Mero. Coming back yeah. February 3rd. And people are like, why are you taking a long break? And it's like, because we can, nigga. Fuck you want to do about it?
Yeah, let me explain something to y'all.
Explain something. Talk
explain
to them.
Y'all. We have been in the television industry for half a decade. It sounds longer than 5 years when
yeah,
you say
yeah.
half a decade.
Yeah, yeah. I
We've
like
been
that.
In the
like
industry
that.
For half a decade. The way the seasons work is there's quarters.
Mm-hmm.
And we started a little late because we wanted to give you a quality program. Therefore, we had to take a mid-season break. And we're coming back on schedule with all your other favorite TV programs, such as, like... shit that's on Showtime.
There you go. There you go.
The more you know.
The more you know.
Thank you.
They're like, yeah, that's cool, but you know what? You guys are not going to be on TV. This is whack. But now it gives us time to like do shit. And
you know
like, you know, we have new shit to talk about.
Yeah,
so,
nigga, you know what I'm saying? Come on, when we come back, you know what time it is, baby?
You know the fucking vibes.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Ain't shit change. Ain't shit change. Oh man, a lot of things going on. Have
yeah,
you signed up?
Things.
Do you guys have a Disney Plus?
Hell no, because everybody's like, yo, that shit don't even really work
yeah,
yet. And I'm like, yo, The Mandalorian. I was like, yo, chill. If that shit's all up on my statement, I might get divorced.
Well, I got.
Shorty, like, yo, was that The Mandalorian with some bitch? You motherfucker! Are you trying to hide it under the
Mandalorian
Disney Plus
sounds
bill?
Like a hotel that in a Cameron lyric.
Yo, it's me and Shorty, man, at the Mandalorian. Mandalorian.
I saw her baby Yoda. I was yeah. in Ray Liotta.
Yo, me and Ray Liotta seeing Baby Yoda. Then we drank a little maple soda. Like, what the fuck is a maple soda?
We had to wait. The Uber was a wild Toyota. They're like, oh, man. I was like, yeah. If you still listen to Cam in 2019, you have at one time in your life, you faced a felony.
Oh, for sure.
Easily.
For sure. And you was like, fuck a plea deal, nigga.
If you still listen to Cam, like, you the type of nigga that you've thought about fucking up your lawyer.
Yo, facts.
You've been in there like,
yo, Silverstein.
Yo, what
yo,
the fuck?
Yo, you not banging for me, my nigga, for real.
Yo, Jeremy.
What the fuck's wrong
this
with you, man?
This ain't fucking Fordham law, nigga.
Come on, son.
I'm fighting for my fucking life.
Come on.
Yeah. I was actually thinking yesterday, I was like, was beating a gun charge better than having the show picked up for a second season? And I'm going to say no, it wasn't.
Nah, because no. You could have 3 years.
3 years in jail. 3 years in jail is whack, but, you know, like, I mean it would have changed my trajectory. I wouldn't have done the TV show, but I probably have better stories. I'd be a mean barber.
Yo, what?
I'd be a mean barber.
Yo.
Not an official barber, but a mean barber.
Just, yeah, like, yo, nigga, man. Y'all niggas is pussy. Like, yo, my man. Mm-hmm. Like, I just tipped you $20. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but you still pussy though, nigga. Yeah, that nigga. Right. That's your cousin, nigga? That nigga's pussy. Nigga shaping you up the whole time. You just mad scared in the chair like, Nigga take out the straight razor. You start shivering.
Nah, niggas coming for a haircut and shit. I'm like, oh, word. You getting a haircut? Yo, let me ask you something. You like hip-hop?
Word?
I be making beat. Matter of fact, hold on. Let me.
I got, I focus on, like, you know, I got French Montana and shit. Like, you like
this
saying?
You like this beat? Like, young kids don't know nothing about this right here. Like,
I fuck with my nigga. Okay.
Okay. Oh, like, shit. I made this shit.
Okay.
This back when I had a coke flow, you know what I'm saying?
Shit.
Like,
okay.
This is like some kind of hip hop. Yeah.
You know the fucking vibe.
All right. Yeah. Okay.
You know, I'm gonna just let this beat ride for like 5 minutes.
Yeah, I got somewhere to go. I gotta go to work.
Nah, we not.
I came early.
You know what? Matter of fact, thank you for blessing me and saying that beat was hot. I'm gonna go downstairs and make some more. So I'll see you tomorrow.
Ew. Like, nigga, leave me half in shape up. I got one pointy ass sideburn and shit.
Shit.
The other half of my face look like Abraham Lincoln.
Abraham Lincoln.
Yo, you go to Dominican barbershop, nigga, that shit is it's a day party.
That shit, they do everything but cut hair.
Yo, Dominican barbershops invented day parties, dog. All y'all niggas pay homage, yo.
Oh, shit. I just don't understand. Like, when did it just become okay to just smoke hookah all the time?
All day.
All the time.
Like, yo, hey, papi, I'm going to call you here, but first I'm going to smoke some hookah, argue with my baby mother.
Was hookah illegal in the early 2000s? Because it wasn't around, and it just showed up out of nowhere.
Ask Julio if he cares.
True. I think the saddest part of New York now is how you go to a bodega and a bodega will sell hookah, but they won't sell beer.
That's wild.
I was like, what the
Yo, and like, they got some wild hookahs too. Like, yo, the AK-47 hookah and shit. Like,
they got a hookah shit like Sarah J. Like,
yo, come on, man. Niggas,
do we not start? We just start the pino thing. It's too late. Sorry, guys.
Nigga said it's Sarah J. hookah.
Sarah J. hookah.
She got two hoses coming out.
Nigga smoking on the butt like,
oh, yeah. She's like, oh, yeah.
Sarah J.'s face is like, yo.
Yeah.
But the body's like, yo.
Yeah. It's like if you got a Bentley and you behind the shit in traffic and then you pull up to the nigga and the front end is crashed up, you're like, oh, damn. But yo, fuck, it's a Bentley. That back end was a Bentley, boy.
I don't even think we're like 20 minutes in.
Who cares?
But you know what?
You know what I'm saying?
Hey. Look at us. Huh? Who would have thought?
You would have thought
me.
Sucio boys, you know what I'm saying? We out
Sucio
here.
Sucio boys, you know, Sucio gang. For them nasty niggas. Nasty people.
Yeah.
If you've ever logged on to Pornhub on someone else's computer,
you nasty motherfucker.
If you ever streamed porn on someone else's Wi-Fi, you know you're not supposed to.
Dog.
If you ever saved a porn clip to your desktop just in case the Wi-Fi ain't working because you felt a certain way about it. You're a Sucio boy.
Or
a Sucio girl.
Yeah.
Or a Sucio them.
You know what I'm saying?
We out here. We're inclusive.
You know what I'm saying? All the whole Sucio spectrum, mm-hmm. nigga. Sucio spectrum.
Yeah. That's the name of our gang. We got Sucio spectrum gang shirts coming. That's too hot. Sucio spectrum.
You know what I'm saying?
I don't understand why you're nasty. Because I'm on the Sucio spectrum, mom.
Mom.
Okay.
Okay.
He's gonna come out and be
I'm
like, "Yo,
I'm
Sucio spectrum.
I'm Sucio not conforming."
Damn. Wow. Okay. Sucio spectrum sounds like a show that used to come on PBS. It was like mad positive, taught you how to read and shit.
Ken Burns presents pornography.
Sucio spectrum.
Oh wow. This is wild.
Niggas is wildin'.
Somebody suck that baby dick.
We gotta do a retrospective. We gotta find out that baby, what he's up to now.
Yeah.
How his life changed after that.
Behind the music.
The baby. Behind that baby.
He's like, "Aaron, man, you know what I'm saying? What inspired me to get into the rap music business was I was at the club one night, you know what I'm saying? I was just cooling my peoples and all that. And then, you know, Cuba Gooding Jr., I remember him from Snow Dogs, you know, because I just got Disney Plus, and I remember him. And then he gave me a motherfucking shout out on stage, and I said, "God damn, man."
He is from North Carolina, you know, so it's possible he was in the club as a baby.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying?
In North Carolina, I think you have to be like seven years old to get in.
That's the legal
Yo, big man, no sippy cups.
Yo, my man, that shit got two handles.
Yo, the pull-ups. Nah,
fam.
Dub,
nah,
no, can't come in here, no pull-ups.
Nigga's like, damn. Nigga like, got a 22 in the pull-ups. Like, damn.
Gaga Google. Nigga fight with the bouncer. Got Matt Drew coming out.
Gaga.
Nah, big man.
Nigga's having big a tantrum. Man. Like, damn.
Big man, you got to take that tantrum outside.
Gaga.
Big man.
Yo, big man.
Someone, big man, you need a nap.
Mine.
Big man.
Mine.
Big man, use your words.
Mine.
Big man. Yo, big man. Big man, time out.
I want my
big man, you're going to put you on time out.
No.
Big man, no more Paw Patrol.
No.
All right? Big man, you hungry?
Yeah.
Okay, big man, come over here. I'll make you some ravioli. All right?
Okay.
Big man, sleepy, right?
Yeah, sleepy.
Uncle Victor in the house.
Hey, have mercy.
Have mercy.
Hey.
For that dark episode of Full House where Uncle Joey walks in and Bob Saget is just sitting on the couch and he's just like, did something bad.
Oh, what'd you do?
They're dead.
What'd you do, Danny?
What you said to do, I cut them out.
What do you mean that? What do you mean cut them out? I mean, what do you mean?
The girls, I cut them out. Like, life. Who? Go to the attic.
Whoa. I'll see you later.
This is episode not on Disney Plus. Okay. I guess it's not so Full House.
Yeah, it's empty house now, nigga. Smelly house on the block.
It's just Uncle Joey and the other guy just digging graves in the back. Dark.
He's like, they got one hand up doing the bullwinkle.
He's
like,
they're crying. Like, and then what happens? Shorty from next door, Gibbler, comes over. He's like, yeah. What are you guys doing?
Hey, what are you guys doing?
She's like, they got to take her out.
Yeah. You know who's from Blossom? Six.
Yeah.
Six. Yo, she was a size six.
Six.
Yeah. Yo,
six had the yeeks.
Yeah.
But she was short.
Yeah.
So that throws it off. But she did have the yeeks.
Shout out to her.
Remember, she was in a cinematic classic that is The Parkers. Dang, mama.
That wasn't her name. It was something else.
It was something else.
It was like some like fucking, her name was like Mashalu or some shit.
Jenna Van Oy.
Yo,
Jenna Van Oy. Damn, Google is messy as shit. Like, the second question is, she still married? Because you know niggas be thirsting.
Oh,
like, yo.
Oh, shit. Like, yo, six. You still six? You still got that hat with the flowers on it?
Oh.
What's Joey Lawrence doing right now besides cocaine?
Oh, wow. Six, separated from her husband, is now engaged to a woman.
Oh, shit. Shout out to her.
Shout out to her.
Live your truth, sis.
You know what I'm saying? She, huh? This is Sucio Spectrum.
You know what I'm saying? Out here, gang.
Should we come to Jenna, you want us to come to your party?
Yo, what?
Come
see your, we'll your wedding.
That's a new thing we're doing in 2020. We, for the right amount of money, you don't want, listen, we're talking Dave Tutera prices, okay?
Yeah.
Get your money up.
Six figures.
All right? At the least, just for the consultation. But you know we will do your nuptials.
Oh, the whole thing.
Whole thing. We'll do a podcast at your nuptials.
Boom.
How about that?
And you know what I'm,
you gotta pay extra. We might bring Victor. You got to pay a lot extra for Victor. Victor don't like to travel.
Victor come out and be
Victor not coming for less than seven figures.
Straight up.
It's always extra, baby.
Hey!
Call him Young Guac, baby.
Yeah. Young Guacamole.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay. Yo, you take this bitch to be your wife?
Yo. Yo, word. I fuck with her.
You fuck with her? All right. You take this nigga to be your husband and shit?
Yeah, that nigga's cool. He's cool.
All right. You know what happens? Like, when you meet a bitch, you a nigga, like, y'all fucks with each other.
Yeah, I bang with
and
this nigga.
And sometimes you gotta, like, fuck with each other in front of people and in front of God and shit.
Word, word.
So, you know what? That's why y'all niggas is here today at this community center.
That's what's up.
And you know what? I hope these niggas fuck with each other for a long time. If they don't, you know what I'm saying? Like, shit, you know, shit happens and shit. But, yo, you could kiss the fucking bitch now.
Word,
nigga.
Word.
Kiss that bitch.
Yo, you know what? Matter of fact,
express your love for her. Please, put the black Air Force One on her foot.
Oh, shit. Yo.
Thank you.
Here you go, ma.
Everyone's like, that shit is beautiful, dog.
You may not stack with the bride.
That's right. Oh, shit. Oh, shit. Oh, block. Free the homies. The problem is if we do offer that, it's going to be mad white people ordering it.
Like the fucking move, like the shit when Project Pat showed up at that white people's wedding out of nowhere.
Oh, my God. You're going to see us on TMZ. It's going to be TMZ. They're going to be like, Desus and Mero performed a wedding at a slave plantation.
They did niggas like, in Paris 10 times.
For the record, the bag was correct. Niggas just run to the airport with mad money and shit.
Shit coming out the bag.
Yeah.
I got news for you. Them weddings still happen on plantations down south.
Oh, I mean, listen.
I've been to one. It was uncomfortable. Because I'm not going to name it, but they called it a hall. So I was like, oh, okay, we're going to like a venue. And I was like, so we're on like the tour bus.
Yeah.
We're riding. Yeah. It's going smooth. It gets bumpy. It's a dirt road. It's nothing but trees. Yeah. I think I hear the banjo from Deliverance. And lo and behold, we arrived at the hall, and I was like, I know we're in Buford, South Carolina right now, and I know we used to go out
here. You feel that big fucking KKK energy.
It was beautiful, though. Beautiful.
Oh, man. That's wild. People, like, who was like, oh, where's a romantic place to have my wedding? A plantation.
A plantation.
What the fuck? Like, why would you have your wedding on a plantation with La Marina's right there?
Right there.
Right there.
Right there, dog. All
right.
Come on, son.
Listen, I am going to be the Ernest Hemingway of La Marina. I'm going to write so many books about how beautiful La Marina was, about romances there, about my childhood growing up on the shores of La Marina. I'd spend the morning in the sand, and my mother would go, son, come back away from the waves.
Back, back.
And I'd say, no, ma. No.
I would hear the gentle rhythm of the dembo.
The dembo calls me.
And I remember the scent of the hookah.
I saw a Dominican mermaid in the Hudson River. And she was like, yo,
yo, what's
yo
good?
My
yo.
Nigga, come here. Yo,
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 yo, yo, you pussy nigga. What's good? Yo, you buying drinks, yo? Papi, tu no gata.
The siren song of the mermaid caused many ships to crash. Everyone's like, wow.
Wow.
Everyone's like, wow.
Wow, that's a rare merch happy.
Wow. It's about like a sailor.
She's just holding
a fisher, a fisherman that lives his family.
She's just holding her fucking bundles up, trying to do shit. Yo, yo, I'm not getting any shits wet. Fuck out of here.
Played by who? Dasha Polanco.
Come on,
you know it. Dasha, we got a job for you.
You know the fucking
you know
guys?
What it is. Oh,
yeah, shit.
As I drove my boat to SS Backpage through these torrid waters. Oh.
Yeah.
Listen.
Damn, son. Every time I hear that name, though, I'm just like, man, Backpage, yo.
Gone, baby. Well, I told you about the new one, so keep going a little. But, Sucio Spectrum, right? Right? Now it's on some whisper shit. You're like,
yo, yo, it's a secret society. All we ask is trust.
All it takes is one person. All it takes is one person to break the trust.
That's it.
You know?
You know what I'm saying? Then, yo.
Then the trust is gone.
You know what I'm saying? And you know what time it is. You know what I'm saying?
Gotta bust the guns.
You know what I mean?
You know what I'm saying?
You are the weakest link. Goodbye.
Oh.
Mm. Hey, 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 hey.
I don't know what you was just doing to the camera, but sir, I'm gonna need you to chill.
Yo,
doing a lot, my guy.
Oh my god, oh I love it.
Oh, what else happened this week? Oh, the Knicks. Shout out to the Knicks. They won
a game.
Three quarters of a game against Philadelphia.
Yeah,
didn't win the fourth quarter, but you know.
But yo, they were scrappy.
It was fun for three quarters.
They did back down,
you know,
until they got steamrolled in the fourth quarter.
I guess it's like having bad kids. You got to find the good side and shit.
Yeah.
So
it's like, yo,
he didn't bite anyone in school today.
You know what? He called his teacher a bitch and he smacked her, and that's very problematic, but you know what? At least he got an A on the science test.
There you go. It all balances out.
It all balances out
in the end.
In the end. They don't make enough songs about suicide anymore. What's a good rap song about suicide?
Suicidal like, thoughts. I feel like, is there any other one?
Well, that wasn't a good song. He was, like, bitching.
Is it Mind Playing Tricks on Me? Low-key about
no, it's about, like, drugs himself? And shit. Like, he's like, yeah, I want to kill himself. It's about mental trauma and shit. Oh. Like, you know, like, he's punching the ground and shit. I guess there's no good songs. Good songs about suicide.
Yo, Logic is hurt somewhere right now if he's listening to this.
Oh, yeah. I just want to fucking die. I'm like, nigga, how do you sing that melodically?
He is quietly devastated somewhere here in this lander.
He's like, man.
We've been throwing a lot of shots at Logic, and I have no idea why. I don't feel that strongly about it, but it's just right there. I've given it. You know what it is? It's like, oh, I figured out what it is. It's like Bernie Bros. People who really fuck with Bernie Sanders.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying I'm against Bernie Sanders. Like, we interviewed him on a show. No one showed like, you know, this, you know the vibes. You know the vibes. You know
what I'm saying?
You know the fucking vibes.
So, like, we posted a picture with Elizabeth Warren. And then mad people in the Instagram comments who fuck with Bernie were in there just been like, get Pocahontas out of here. All this wild shit. And I'm like, yo, y'all kind of doing shit that Trump voters do. And is that why people don't really fuck with Bernie? Because the people who fuck with Bernie are assholes? Which doesn't make any sense if you think about it, because if you should like a candidate because of their policies and stuff. But like if a bunch of cornballs support them, Andrew Yang, then that's what's gonna happen.
Yo,
okay?
Yeah, I'm like, yo, I can't bang with y'all. I can't be part of this gang, nigga. Y'all niggas is called goofballs.
If to possible, you know, we from the Bronx, okay? We like that guy that was out on the West Coast. He was like, I'm out here by myself. I'm from New York.
I'm by myself. The nigga was in Arizona, though.
Damn, how you get washed it? But you know what? As a true New York nigga, still on Twitter. And he got that shit in his body. He's like, I'm the nigga from the video. He's still alive. Niggas ain't kill him.
His banner's him like that. Yeah. Fucking cobra yoga position.
He caught a beating, but he's still alive.
Shout to him. Listen, there's no shame in getting your ass beat. You know what I'm saying? If you get jumped, like, you're not going to fight four niggas.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like, you got your ass beat.
Listen, if you live to be there next day, you know, you'd be good. And then you have options. You're like, you can ride on them. You can come back. You can bring back that thing.
You know what I mean?
Even though if four niggas jump you, you can't shoot all four niggas. You got to shoot just one.
You got to shoot one and be like, yo.
Everyone knows we got the wild problematic group chat. It's me, you, Steph Myers, Trevor Noah, and Jimmy Fallon. We just be sending pictures.
We be sending each other pictures
of guns we bought. I'm like, yo, Jimmy, look at this PPK. He's like, yeah. I love it.
He's like, love it. Look at your man laughing emojis and shit. Like, yo, what? Is it funny?
Woo.
The pistol's funny to you, nigga.
Pistol's funny.
Yo, LeBron dapped up Kobe and it started an uproar and shit.
That why?
I don't know, because the Kobe stands are like, yo,
LeBron, Kobe stands.
Like, yo, you'll never be Kobe, nigga. You know what
Kobe
I'm saying?
Kobe stands are wild.
They are wild.
I respect them, though.
They're wild.
Because you'll be having, like, you're talking about a totally different sport thing, and they'll just come through like Kobe was the best.
Yeah.
Like, I'll be like, yo, do you really think Chapman is, like, more reliable than Mariano?
Kobe's the GOAT.
Oh, we were talking baseball, but.
Yeah, but not Kobe's the GOAT. Okay. If you think about it, rings, clutch, you know what I'm saying? With Shaq, without Shaq.
Okay, we were talking baseball relievers. Like, how is Kobe?
Well, because Kobe's cousin, he pitched in the minor leagues for the Scranton Billy Bobs. So then what happened was that he, you know what I'm saying, he taught Kobe how to play baseball, and that helped him in his game as
somebody
basketball.
Suck that baby. Somebody suck that baby's dick.
Oh, yo, Cuba.
Motherfuckers do mental gymnastics.
They do.
To explain how Kobe is the best ever.
It is. And you know what? I'm kind of biased because I did see Kobe. Oof, he put it on the Knicks once.
Yeah.
That time he set the scoring title on the Masters. That was something.
Was the best Kobe Lil Afro Kobe or like prime hairline Kobe or like struggle hairline Kobe?
The best Kobe I would have to say was. Let me see.
Yo, you wasn't with me shooting in the gym, Kobe.
No, I want to say
Afro number 8 because he was still jumping out the gym.
Yeah, he was out there.
That's a good Kobe.
But the shoes was trash.
Better than? But was it better than?
Oh, Oh shit!
Thug Poet Kobe.
Oh shit! Kids, tell you what you don't know. Kobe, yeah, he's real with the flow. Kicking the dough, waving the flow, blow. All you heard was stop. Can't take the hits no. Can't take the hits no more. Bend the flow, blow. All you heard was stop. Can't take the hits no more. Ha. Didn't know I had your block on SWAT. I'm CIA. Y'all nothing but beat cops.
Wow. Yo. Now I see you. What David Stern was in his office like? What the
God
fuck is this
damn.
Shit?
What I low-key peep from this is like, yo, did Blueface grow up on this? Is this Blueface's favorite album?
I'm telling y'all, Blueface is going to be deemed as one of the greatest lyricists in hip-hop. And everyone's like, that's bullshit, but you got to think about it like this.
He's like, I shoot a nigga and leave him looking like a bagel.
Yeah.
Nigga, I'm a bagel. I'm like, yo, what the fuck?
But we grew up listening to like Rakim, Nas, all that stuff. So we've been listening to lyrics for years. Yeah. Think about if you're like 12, 13. He sounds like the dopest rapper you ever heard, and you're just gonna stick with it. And it's like, as he grows, you grow, and you're gonna be like, yo, he's gonna be someone's Jay-Z.
Oh, wow.
And we can't look down and be like, nah, that nigga's whack. Cause I saw someone on Twitter yesterday was like, Jay-Z is at best, average rapper. Ooh. I have never in my life wanted to find someone's IP address and go beat the shit out of them. How dare you? Like, we got jokes about Jay-Z, but you do not disrespect Jay-Z's rapping ability ever.
Look.
You can disrespect the fact he looks like a camel, the fact he cheated on Beyonce, the fact he sold out the NFL, threw Kaepernick under the bus,
anxiety
wearing express shirts in 03.
All the athletic pictures of him, all that shit.
Okay.
But the lyricism?
The lyricism?
Nah.
Okay.
Stop.
Triple entendre, don't even ask me how.
Stop.
Ask me this.
Did
Jay-Z say, I can sell water to a well.
That's right.
Or I can sell water to a
whale. One of the great mysteries of life.
And the thing is, either one works.
They both work.
They both work.
Stupid.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying?
I know he did that. And Beyonce was like, wow.
Yo.
Wow.
Just put on So Ghetto and tell me he's an average rapper. You know what I'm saying?
Well, no. There's like, and then people are saying like he used to be good. Now he's not good. His latest, like he doesn't do verses anymore. But when he does a verse, you're just like, holy shit.
Oh, wow.
He still got it.
Wow.
Like, we did
he don't need to do verses anymore, though. That's like people being like, yo, like, fam, like, yo, Prince got to play the guitar to prove that he's still good.
Right.
Like, no, nigga, this nigga's nice. It's just, it was like riding a bike. Once you're good, you good. Like, there's no rap muscle that, like, tears. You can't tear your rap ligament. You know what I'm saying?
No, like, there's been some people who've torn their rap ligaments. There's definitely some rappers like,
is there anybody in the
They drop a new
green.
Shit, and you're like, you get the concert, they're like, yo, can I do some new music?
Police!
No, you gotta really fuck with the musician for when they do new music. You'd be like, yo, all right, because you never heard it before and they're singing it, and then you always got the assholes at the concert trying to sing along even though knowing the words.
They're
like, love in heaven. Thank you guys.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Nah.
And then leaving out in the no encore. No
Are night. We gonna start playing instruments this year?
We should.
Because I realized last night, whatever we do, we can't be stopped. So like, let's just take over the world. I think we should become. Well, the Sucio Spectrum should be a group. Justin, you play instruments? No, fuck. You could be the vocalist. Okay, we're playing Coachella 2021.
I got it right now.
What's Ezra doing? Call him right now. Tell him to come through.
He's coming through.
We got Lizzo.
Yo, shout to God on those 3 Grammy noms, though.
Shout to him.
Shout to, yo, you know what I'm saying? I hit him up. I was like, yo, you got more Grammy noms than a nursing home got granny moms. I was so high. Yeah, he was just like, yo, LOL.
Yeah,
he's
boo.
Like, thanks.
Boo.
Thanks, man.
Boo.
He's like, yeah, man, thanks. Appreciate it, man. I put a lot of hard work, man.
Yeah. So we can perform in Coachella 2021. We're headlining it. So Coachella, get that shit together.
That shit.
It's going to be great.
We're going to recreate we're going to do like the motherfucking.
We're not coming on stage till 4 a.m.
Diverse. Yeah, yeah, yes.
So when you, you guys are going to watch the shitty live stream that's wild choppy. Here we go about that.
Hello, Coachella.
Thank you for waiting for Sucio Spectrum.
Sucio Spectrum. I thought a guitar in the air before we even started. Shit hit me in the head. I'm like,
oh. Could I have a medic to the stage, please? Can I say Can I have a medic to the stage, please?
Yeah.
Sucio, he's bleeding profusely from his head.
Slapping the bass, mate.
Can we, yeah. Okay, so we came here to, you know, perform.
Yeah, man.
For Coachella.
That's right.
My name is Sucio Spectrum. My partner is concussed on the floor
right now.
You're right, then, mate.
We are Sucio Spectrum. We're here to perform for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, we did a Linkin Park show. We just have Hasan in the background. DJ like, mad aggressively. Like,
I'm like, yeah, you're just here, you know.
I never thought.
We're just, just tuning up, tuning up guitars, mate.
Out, mate.
A lot of people don't know.
Say, mate. Get ready.
There's a Spectrum.
That's right.
And a Sucio.
That's right, man. Glastonbury, make some noise.
And Coachella, you having a good time?
Yeah, well, that's what we are. We're Coachella. I'm sorry, Coachella. I'm concussed. Fuck, I'm on concussion protocol.
Ezra, can I get an F? You guys want an encore?
Yeah!
We're bringing out, yeah! We're gonna
do it, yeah! Somebody fucked up, baby!
Kyle's like, woo!
Somebody fucked up, baby!
Cuba! We love you, Cuba!
Yeah!
Cuba is a genius.
Oh my god.
Oh my god. It'd be like when Ariana Grande brought out Justin Bieber.
Yeah.
Oh. He was like, just keep drinking and drinking and drinking. You know you want to get
fucking wasted.
Just carry him out the suck that baby's dick.
Yeah. Duh.
That'd be a great show, not for like a real network, for probably like Viceland. If you just spent the whole day with Cuba Gooding Jr.?
Yo.
With cameras?
Yo.
Yeah.
But would he be on his best behavior?
No, because the camera's there. He'd have to behave. But what I think happens is, like, as the day goes longer, like...
He just can't resist?
Yeah. Days go by. I ain't never about you. Without you.
He ends up at a fucking Emmy's after party or some shit. And it's just like, yo. There's a big-ass jug of Tanqueray just sitting right there.
That's just calling him. He's like, hi, Cuba.
Hey, Cuba.
Cuba, you're thirsty.
Hey, would you like some Tanqueray?
Cuba, put me in your mouth.
Yeah.
Don't you want to have fun?
Yeah. You want to have fun? You
wanna everyone have wants to have fun. Time.
Hey.
Everyone wants to. All the fucking beers are like. The beers are swag surfing and shit.
She says it's the fucking Beauty and the Beast.
We swag. We surf. We swag. We surf. We swag. We surf. You drink us. You thirst.
Yeah.
It's like a bad Disney movie. It's like, ah. Ah.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Y'all remember this?
Ooh. Oh my god.
Little Dirty Vegas.
Oh shit.
Little Days Go By.
Oh shit, yo. Yo, fuck, I'm not. Yo, open the Molly pill and just fucking just, fuck open, it just open it in. Fuck it.
Oh my god, I just thought about the Desus that I was when this song came out and whoa.
Nigga.
Nigga. Even I'm scared.
Woo.
Wow. Woo. Wow, I was wilding. Like, you look now, we're old enough to look back and be like, I made some very bad choices. I have no idea how this shit worked out.
Yeah.
But,
yeah, that's what I remember driving, to a lot of...
I remember driving in a car with... Jesus. Oof, let me not even. Because some of this stuff, like, there's a cop, like, we got him. We got him.
That was it.
He just confessed.
That was the break in the case.
And it's not... You don't get caught for, like, any drug charges. He's like... The same way they call Al Capone on, like, taxes or whatever, they're going to catch us for, like, ripping a tag off a mattress or some bullshit. Oh, he shopped us to the Jimmy Jazz back in 93.
Guess what?
Guess what the statute of limitations on that is? 40 years, pal.
This guy opened the fucking fire hydrant on 176th Street and Morris Avenue.
Oh, wow. He's going down.
Yeah.
He's going down.
That's right. He's not supposed to have that wrench. That's property of FDNY. That's a federal offense.
Wow.
This guy's going down.
I heard that guy, Victor, the mastermind.
Yeah.
One time he swiped the MetroCard.
Yeah.
It's a swipe again at this turnstile.
He went to another one. For you believe that guy?
Felony.
Fucking
actually, the MTA was trying to make that a felony. MTA's like, we need all the money, baby.
Yo, come on, baby.
They're going to be like, yo, you stand over the yellow line? Felony.
Felony, nigga.
The cops just arrest you for shit.
Yo, you sit on the bench next to another person? Felony.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? Yo, you look at a poster for too long? Felony.
How they got no money for trains, but they just added like 500 new cops? And so every time you go to the train station, there's mad cops just standing around. Shouldn't they be out there solving a crime or some shit?
Yeah. Every time you see a cop show, it's like they solve a crime in 30 minutes or less.
Yeah, that's not how
it
works.
But I be watching NYPD, them niggas are sitting there on Instagram and shit, like liking pictures of butts.
And I'm going to say this, and it's going to get me in trouble, I'm sure. As now that I'm older than most cops, that I'm looking at them, I'm like,
you took this for a job. Like, when you're younger, you look at cops, you're like, they're so brave, they're heroes, they're big. And I'm like, look at Jose from down the block. This suit don't even fit right.
Yo, let me tell you something. If you were in a public high school, New York City public high school right now, and all the niggas that is in ROTC,
oh my God,
they about to be cops. I'm like, 10 years.
I remember in college, my biology lab partner, who I just got, they made me work with him. I was like, yo, what's going to be your major? He was like, just trying to get 20 college credits so I could be a cop. I was like, what? You're not? I was like, so you're going to do half a year of college?
You're going
to
spend money, not get a degree.
He's like, fuck this. As soon as I get them 20, I'm out. And he, like, left halfway through.
Nigga took five gym classes and left.
I was like, you should not be a cop, my nigga. He's like, William Bratton now. So, I'm kidding.
Yo, every nigga that I know that's a cop, I'm like, you shouldn't be a cop.
Yeah.
I'm like, you became a cop for all the wrong reasons,
my
nigga.
To be fair, though, there's a parallel world with me and you are cops. Not the best cops. The new characters. The worst corrections officers in the world. Oh, shit. Larry. Yeah, you seen the keys for D Block 5?
Oh, shit.
Oh, they're running around. I must have left it open. Fuck.
Okay.
All right, get the gun.
Whatever. You want to go check on that guy? The fucking, what's his name?
Jeffrey F. All right, let's go see. That's it.
Oh, okay.
Well,
killed himself.
Yeah.
All right, you got the little checklist?
Take the noose off of him and make it look like he was napping.
Yeah,
we're fine. All right, guys, listen. Fine. I don't feel like piping up any paperwork.
Jeez, come on, bro.
No one even cares who he is.
Fuck him. Rich white guy
dies in jail. They don't even make the news.
Yeah, fucking Petrulli and Johnson.
Listen,
are coming
in next. We got 10 more weeks and we retire out this bitch at 25. That. So we get, you know, we good.
Yeah. Epstein's gonna kill himself.
It was a rap party yesterday. I'm still hungover, nigga. I was singing Creep with the fucking staff and not the TLC version. I was like, I'm a loser. How did I get here? I'm a creep. Yo. That's a weird song. Like, if you sing that on a date and you're just like singing, looking at the girl, like,
yo, my go to karaoke song is always Hey Ma, because it's very lighthearted. You know what I'm saying? Mm. I'm 18 and live a crazy life. You know what I'm saying? I can tell you what the 80s like.
Your go to karaoke song should never be a rap song.
What?
That is some Bronx shit. It should be a melodic song that other people can sing along to.
But that's the thing, though.
I remember I was with my boy, and you know what his karaoke song was?
What?
Nas Made You Look.
Oh, nah.
Who the fuck was like that? Everyone just sat down.
But you know what? Hey Ma makes it. Hey Ma got the little piano, and it's kind of like, hey, we're having fun.
To you.
But like, you can't throw on like Uncle Murda and do fucking karaoke.
First of all, what karaoke place has Uncle Murda?
I was going to say, if a karaoke place has Uncle Murda, I feel like you have to do it.
Yo, what?
The only place that has it.
Welcome to East Farragut karaoke, my nigga.
Yo, East New York karaoke, nigga.
You doing Mano. All we got is Mano, Troy Ave.
Red Cafe,
and Uncle Murda. Okay? Yo, I want to dedicate this song to my bitch. She's having my baby, saying, yo.
Word up.
Bitch like a gun, yo.
Yo.
I'm on the run, yo. And what's that like, yo, this shit hot.
Yo, they got Old Fabulous and shit.
Damn.
It's a welcome to newly married couple, and it's do Superwoman.
Be your super. Boy. I'm like, this sounds real. I'm like, Little Mo's right there.
She's
performing it for
actually
real.
Little Mo.
She's actually the bartender.
Yeah.
I will be your superwoman. I'm also being a server. My specialist for the day. We have catfish.
We have
you can eat it right
broccoli
at the bar
cheddar soup and a bread bowl.
We got spaghetti cut up with Frank's. Which we hit.
Just straight spaghetti. Yo, I survived those straight spaghetti for mad long.
Here we go. This fucking coon over here.
Yo, straight spaghetti.
Why don't you just admit it? Why don't you just fucking admit it? You've been taking checks from Big Spaghetti for a while.
I mean,
or you're always pushing the spaghetti agenda.
Look,
spaghetti at the beach.
Yo,
I enjoy spaghetti.
Listen, spaghetti's mad easy to steal, mad easy to prepare. If you fuck up spaghetti, you ahead. Like, I don't even know what to say about you, my nigga. If you fuck spaghetti, that shit says, yo, put boil water, put spaghetti in the water, put some salt in that shit, leave it in there for 8 minutes. That's it. Some if you can, fuck that up.
Some people cannot cook spaghetti.
Yo.
I have been with people who cannot cook spaghetti. And I'll just be like, yo. I'm like, yo, are you serious?
Yo, who raised you?
Like, not. But then the problem is sometimes you be like, yo, who raised you? And then you got to hear some fucking sob story that explains why. And they're like, well, man. I don't know how to cook spaghetti because my mother was on drugs. And I was like, oh, shit. Like,
that don't matter. Sorry. Because al dente is an art. Okay? Al dente is an art. That's on you.
That's true. Because if the shit said, it tells you 7 minutes al dente, 8 minutes, you know what I'm saying? Like, et cetera, al dente. Shout out to Barilla. Al dente perfection.
Yo, DZ, you were right.
Big spaghetti.
Al dente
big
perfection.
Big spaghetti. Shout out to this motherfucker knows the name of a spaghetti brand.
And she gets me tight is as Dominican. I thought you would have been taking money from Big Espaghetti's.
Yeah.
But nah, you sold out.
He sold out. Yeah.
You went straight to Big Spaghetti.
Wow. The Food Network nigga over here. This week on the Cooking with the Martinez's. Hi, my name's Heather. This is my husband, Joel.
Hi.
We're going to be making latkes for Hanukkah. It's like a good show, but the problem is like, they'd be like cooking and shit. Like, she'd be making dough. He'd be like, yeah, you rolling that dough.
Just grab that titty and shit.
I got some dough for you. I'm about to put some of your ham and touches. I'm like, this nigga's fucking on the...
Hold me!
I'm like, I would like to report the show when I'm done. Yeah.
The only evergreen cooking show.
Wow. Heather's in charge. Wow. Okay, Mero's moaning. Yeah. Jesus. Wow. Okay, I've never seen that before.
You just see
Jesus.
You just see my ankles. I'm like.
You're like, Sucio Spectrum. Sucio Spectrum. When you just want to see nasty shit.
Nasty shit. No matter who you are.
Sucio Spectrum. Don't mean a thing.
No.
Oh, you Sucio boys don't mean a thing to be.
That's right.
Janet Jackson gonna sue us, but she's gonna call us and be like,
Take it down. Why are you using my side of the thing? Why?
Oh, my. Oh. God, could you imagine if either of us could sing, how annoying this podcast would be?
Oh, my God.
We'd be. No. Actually, our lives would be different because we probably would have went to art school or some bullshit. But we'd be like a hood Lin-Manuel.
Oh, my God.
Thinking about guns and shit.
Oof.
Mm-hmm.
We'd be 10 vocals.
Yeah.
Trust
my gun.
I bust my gun.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There's so many R&B joints out right now that we could G-mix.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
If you call it G-mix, is that less you get away with having to clear the samples?
Yes, exactly.
Your Honor, it was clearly a G-mix.
It was clearly a G-mix. It was stated in the beginning.
It's been said in the Constitution. If you call it a G-mix, if in the beginning of the verse you say this is a G-mix, they do not have to pay for the royalties.
It falls under fair use.
Okay.
Okay.
I would like to use the case of Plessy versus Ferguson, that's how they got the kids into school.
Absolutely.
Using G-mix.
Exactly.
Because they were like, segregation, black kids can't go into the school. They was like, this is the G-mix.
Exhibit A, we have a drop from Fred the Godson saying, this is the G-mix.
This is the G-mix.
Yeah. Thank you.
This is the F-mix.
I rest my case.
This is the ethnics.
The F-mix. Yo, goddamn. Yo, it's about to be cold. You know what I'm saying? So, like, it's people can be indoors a lot. There's going to be a lot of parties going on. You know what I'm saying? So, I just want to give you one piece of advice.
What's that advice, my brother?
Do not have sex in the bathroom at a party.
No. I'm giving you a problematic life for that terrible advice.
You know what I'm saying?
There's nothing hotter than having sex at a house party.
That was the first half of the sentence. Do not have sex in the bathroom at a party when there's only like one or two bathrooms, because then niggas know you fucking in the bathroom. And then everybody's going to be mad at you.
Fuck that. I do what I want.
You know what I'm saying? All right?
If I got to blow some cheeks out and the rest of y'all got to pee in the sink, that's on y'all. Okay?
I'm fucking
nothing better than when you blow someone's back out and all you hear is, hey, get out of there.
Yeah.
Hey, we got to use the bathroom.
No, I can't.
And then she's like, they know what we're doing. I'm like, yeah, you nasty bitch.
Yeah,
let's go.
Yeah.
What's up? Put that plunger in my butt. Have you ever had a house party if you had sex in the bathroom? Like, that happened at one of my New Year's parties. I couldn't do nothing about it. Niggas gotta fuck.
I had a party. I don't know what the fuck possessed us to have a Christmas party at the crib and invite like 100 people to a 2-bedroom Bronx apartment. Yo, I went into my bathroom. There was a nigga throwing up in the sink. A shorty, a dude sitting on the toilet, not taking a shit or going to the bathroom, with shorty on top of him fucking.
Mm-hmm.
And there's a nigga in the bathroom taking a piss, like in the bathtub. Like standing up in the bathtub, pissing down the drain.
That just means the party was lit. That just means the party was lit.
You know what I'm saying? Okay? I can't be mad.
Sometimes you can't be mad at that, okay?
Hey, you know what I'm saying?
It's like,
shit went off.
It was like the time I went to my ex at the time. We went, I don't want to be too much description because she listens, so she would get tight. But we went to a Christmas party that her gay coworker threw. So we went there. There was like mad homeboys and shit. She was mad cool. Niggas was doing tattoos and shit in the house. Niggas was partying. Niggas was vibing. I went outside. I had a conversation with some guy. She loses her shit. She said, I'm trying to leave with this guy. And I was like, what? She's super drunk. And she's going around fighting everyone. Like, oh, no. Is that thing. But she was like 5'2". So I picked her up and I physically threw her into like the bedroom. And I just laid on top of her until she calmed down. And made her very upset. And I was like, no, I'm not getting off of you until you calm down.
Calm down.
And then, yeah, she bit me. But the party was lit.
Yeah, this nigga opened the door and it's just like.
And she, I remember like we were trying to leave and she was fighting because she wanted to get a tattoo. And the guy doing the tattoo, I hadn't seen him like clean off the tattoo gun between any of the tattoos he did.
Boy.
Everyone that got tattooed, the shit got wild infected.
Oh no.
She was lit though.
Nigga just did the tattoo and fucking alcohol, the gun and alcohol. Like, yo,
nah,
no,
he
good.
Did the tattoo. He's like,
Who's next?
Nigga, baby clippers. And I know that was a long time ago because I came with 2 big vats of Moscato.
Oh shit! Yeah.
And everyone was like, "Really?" And I was
really?
Like, "This is what we
really,
drink.
Nigga."
Really? Yeah. So shout out to her, wherever she is. She's dead. But you know, she's cool.
That Moscato was hitting though.
Moscato, listen. People shit on Moscato, but Moscato will catch up. Will creep up on you.
Yeah.
And you don't really feel it at first.
Well, that's sweet shit. All right,
don't
bro.
Bring spaghetti to the beach. Bring some Moscato to the beach. It'll be nice and ripped. Actually, rosé is probably better for the beach.
Bring rosé and spaghetti, because after you eat all that fucking, drink all that alcohol, you're going to need some carbs to soak that shit up, or else you're going to drown.
This is why the municipal fund in New York City is done, because you got Dominicans eating spaghetti and going out there and cramping up, and then the lifeguards have to go save them. Okay? Carbohydrates and children do not belong on the beach.
We're bringing jobs.
You're not bringing jobs. We're not bringing jobs. No spaghetti on the beach. I'm running for mayor, and that's my whole thing. I'm not fixing the trains.
No rent is too damn high.
No rent is too. I'm like, no spaghetti on the beach.
Niggas like, yeah.
Everyone's. They're hopping turnstiles with spaghetti. We're gonna stop the spaghetti. I have a new task force, El Spagatos, and they're gonna keep you guys off the beach.
The Spagato can stop.
They ride on horses.
The Spagato can stop on now.
They're gonna do espagato and frisk.
Espagato.
Hey, pal, you got spaghetti on you? Huh? You got any meatballs in your pocket I should know about?
Yo.
Whoa, what is this? Parmesan cheese?
No.
Yeah, up against the wall. Up against the wall, Chef Boyardee. Yeah.
It's not Parmesan cheese.
Wow.
Wow.
Where you get all this money from, huh? From the Barilla Cartel? I know all about
perico,
you. Get up against the wall.
No. Barilla. Que barilla ni barilla.
Esto
perico, loco.
I seen this before. This guy uptown got a fucking spaghetti flow.
Oh, my God.
Oh, wow.
Este tigre está loco, yo. Yo estoy vendiendo mi vaina aquí. Este tigre de que barilla.
It's sick shit, bro.
Oh,
I used to see it. They used to have little kids working naked up on 138th Street.
Papi, that's not...
They were bagging up spaghetti.
No.
Okay.
I had the naked, the bottle girl that you see in Agua Roja. They was the one that was bagging up for me.
They take the spaghetti, put it in little balls, put it in their butt, and shit it out.
Papi,
they call it Junior Mint. Sick shit.
No, Papi. No, that's not me.
Yeah.
I'm chilling.
All right, Jose Spaghetti.
No, I'm chilling in my fungo house. That's it.
Yeah.
I'm Platinum, man. That's it. I don't do no spaghetti.
You actually get arrested while eating spaghetti. It's like the final scene of Scarface, but instead of cocaine, it's mad spaghetti. Okay, you want to fuck?
You want to fuck with me? Say hello to my little friend. I put like the wild meatball hero, like, wow.
This nigga shooting meatballs. Take cover. Emergency, I need a bus. Officer down. He hit me with a meatball. Nigga bleeding out like. Stay with me, rookie.
I'm leaking marinara.
Oh, shit. Let me see.
Shit.
Oh, it's not Prego. This is bad.
Shit.
It's homemade sauce. Don't die. Don't die on me. Ricotta! Cool guys.
It was just like, gently like,
it was, it's like, is this an ad for a super, is this a Barilla ad?
You go like that with my eyes and it's just mad smeared ricotta cheese on my eyeballs.
I'm like,
Italiano. Hey, Italiano.
I will get you back, but it goes to Italiano. Hey, you sick piece of shit. This is not the Olive Garden. These ingredients are homemade. They say the breadsticks are never ending, but the test says that is not true.
That is not true. You know, I talk that stick talk.
Why does the Olive Garden use that as a promo?
Yo, that's stick,
you know,
talk.
I talk that stick talk. That's stick talk. I feel like Olive Garden is afraid to approach future and be like, yeah, we want you to like use your song for. Navarious?
Navadius. So, but, hey. Got a pitch for you.
Okay.
Hold on. Sensational.
Love your music.
Thank you.
Huge movement. Thank love you. The hair. Love the hats. Stick Talk.
Stick Talk.
I want to talk to you about Stick Talk. Possibly licensing it for a commercial.
Sensational.
Are you okay with appearing in the commercial, engaging in some hospitaliano?
You're pregnant now.
I'm John Mayer, not that John Mayer.
Sensational.
General manager of Olive Garden.
I don't give a fuck if they real sissies.
Oh well, I mean, me neither.
Yeah, you know,
I grew up in Alabama, so yeah. roll tide.
First thing I do when I wake up is grab my trap, nigga. Then I brush my teeth, nigga.
That's great. We can start with that.
Trap niggas.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, maybe not the N word, but you know, maybe if we turn it into like a pasta, like nigga Violi.
Percocet. Molly Percocet.
Yeah. Stuffed Percocet rolls. Yeah, we could do a whole future infused.
Can I add it to my collection?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, we can do that.
One condition.
Are you drinking cough syrup right now?
Yeah, I smoke lean. It's not embarrassing.
I mean, it could potentially be embarrassing corporate.
One connotation for my contract.
And what's that?
I need you to kill Russell Wilson.
Oh yeah, of course. We've been doing it slowly.
Yeah.
Yeah. He goes every weekend to Olive Garden with CC and Little Future.
Yeah.
And he really takes advantage of the never ending breadsticks.
Please
let me tell you.
Please don't call her CC.
Her name's
Sierra.
Okay, all right. Sierra. I apologize.
Thank you.
You ever think Future be somewhere and a Sierra song comes on, he gets tight?
Yeah.
Imagine the guy like just picking up like a hot ready pizza at fucking Papa John's or some shit. It's like, let me see you want to
turn that shit off, my nigga.
Turn that shit off.
Turn that shit off.
Turn that shit off. I got 100 shooters sitting outside.
And they gonna kill you. Let me see you one, two, step.
Hey, turn that shit the fuck off. Turn that shit the fuck off. I wanna hear that shit.
Did Sierra have one good album? Yeah.
She had
Goodies, One, Two, Step, and
Let me see you.
The show Ludacris.
Yeah.
Luda!
If you're in the mood, Body Talk, it goes.
Body Talk!
I feel like that's like at the end of the album.
You know, I'm going to be honest with you.
They were a power couple there, though.
Yeah.
Right?
But you know, even Justin agrees.
You know what some people forget about, which was an amazing song, and I wonder why Sierra and Future didn't make it together? Remember Future made that song,
With Rihanna.
L-O-V-E. Love song. That is a joint.
Yeah.
That is a fuck. Nigga.
Yeah. That's why they broke up, probably.
That's the kind of song where you be like, you go to the shorty, you be like, yo, spit in my mouth.
Yeah.
Like, straight up.
Like, L-O-V-E.
Like, she'll say some nasty, like, she's like, yo, I never sucked on a guy's toes before. Next thing you know, she's sucking on your toes.
Yeah.
Off of that one song. Like, yo. Nasty 4 minutes.
After you take your sneakers off, you got the sock imprint on your foot.
She's like drinking cod liver oil and then spitting in your mouth. Like, it's just nasty shit. Nasty
shorty
shit.
Shorty getting freaky, nasty.
Shorty chugs some toilet water and goes back and forth with you with it. You're like, oh, wow, we wildin'.
Wow.
You're like, this is disgusting, but still better than IHOP.
Yeah. Yo, no IHOP slander, yo, but I went to IHOP the other day, fam, and that shit stayed in my stomach for a full 48 hours.
Well, I mean, to be on the side of IHOP marketing, my nigga, there's nothing international about this house of pancakes.
Okay? Nothing.
All right, it's just pancakes.
Even the Belgian that's waffles is like, nah, we're not Belgian.
That nigga was like, yo, it's international. Because as a kid, you was like, yo.
Oh, they got
that's crazy.
Pancakes from all over the world.
Yo, I can eat the pancakes they eat in Ghana. That's crazy, yo. My nigga. Wow. Yo, they eat a funny face pancake somewhere
else.
What?
yo, I can get a fucking Rudy Tooty Fresh and Fruity.
Yo, that's what they eat in Bangladesh. That's crazy.
That's wild.
International.
Yo,
no, that's not international. International house pancakes is where you take your side chick. Okay?
Facts.
When you're laying low.
Also, I would like to request that IHOP, if I ever get high enough to go there in the future, can y'all please wipe down the syrup bottles? Please?
The wild part is you could probably open an IHOP. Why don't you just make your own IHOP?
I could. I'm going to put an IHOP in my motherfucking crib. Boom. Problem solved.
Okay. I mean, like, it's a franchise, so that's not how it works. You can't.
Well, I can franchise my first store, make it an IHOP, you know what I'm saying? Employ my children, you know what I'm saying?
Now you're talking. You know now you're talking about money talk.
You know what I'm saying? That's how West Indies, West Indies shape, feel me? Dominicano say, so my kids will work before they are legally supposed to. You know what I'm saying?
Your kids are legally supposed to work once the placenta comes out.
Exactly.
Okay?
You know what I'm saying?
Fuck all this Yankee thing about working papers.
No.
You know what your working paper is? Dollars. Yeah. That's your working paper. Yeah.
No. Your working papers, niggas, is your birth certificate. Okay? Motherfucker. Nigga, you're welcome.
I remember being a baby. I was like, cuckoo. 12 bus coming. Gotta go. Boss gonna kill me, bro.
Yo, you checking the app and shit. Like, shit. Yo, it's 2 minutes away. Y'all gotta run.
I don't even know how to walk yet.
Yo.
Are you fucking kidding me? The Yankees. Jeez.
Yo, damn, it's delimited, bro. I wanna buy a Metro.
I think the world disappears when I close my eyes, but even I know I could be a better manager than Girardi.
You look like I'm playing peekaboo. Niggas
just a bunch of babies
science
on a fucking bus and shit. Like,
yeah, what's up, bro?
Wait, it's just not running express.
Nah, give me a fucking fuck, bro. And there comes the fucking baby with the paper shoes, bro.
I hate this shit.
Oh my god,
bro, I only packed 4 Pampers today.
God, this guy's gonna change his diaper in fucking 2 weeks.
Oh fuck,
Jesus fucking Christ,
Jesus. Oh, more applesauce? Are you fucking kidding me? This fucking wife.
Jesus fucking.
Jeez.
God damn it.
Every time, you know, I get home from work and all it's a peekaboo, and then the other day it's like they're talking about fucking tummy time, more like Tommy time.
Yeah,
I want to sit down and watch the fucking Blues Clues.
Come on, give me break here. I've been on a 4-train back and forth all day. God, my neck is tight.
My fucking belly button hasn't even healed up. And this
bitch
talking about can we
kidding
cuddle
me, bro? Shit.
Yeah. And then look at this. Something coming out of my fucking gum.
I don't even know.
What
it's
the
like
fuck
a fucking
shit
bone.
It hurts. It hurts like fucking hell. And
it's
like,
crazy.
You know?
They keep giving me these little round pills. Like, that fucking helps.
They give me a fucking frozen Eggo waffle.
Give
I'm
me
like,
the
good
shit.
Give me something from Target.
Fuck, bro.
Fuck.
Come on, bro.
Give me some of that rum.
Yeah. Fucking turn me into future.
Everyone's like, you just did the cops thing you do, but with babies.
Baby cops.
Baby cops. That'd be an adorable show, but the cops are still racist.
Yeah.
Hey, get over here, caca.
Yeah. Come here.
Imagine a racist baby cop try to arrest you, just kick it.
And bounce. Like, yoink. Just pull his hat over his eyes, like, yo,
I'm like, where'd I go?
He's
like, oh, wait, shit. Hey, I got a report at 10:45.
Suspect. He's in the wind.
Yeah. My description, he's, I don't know colors yet. And,
I
don't know numbers.
He was a daddy guy.
He was okay. He wasn't a horse and he wasn't a chicken.
Yeah.
He was, Google my color and book, page 36.
That's what it was. It was that color and there was, that thing. It was not a zebra, as per my previous report.
Oh shit, baby, my first Sessa. Hey, this is my first time on Earth, long time.
Hey, how you doing?
Excuse me a second.
Maz, let me get another Similac. Go ahead.
Yo. Hey, my friend says a
mic's on,
and he's ready to cry. Yo, he's out here. He didn't get fired.
He didn't get fired. Yeah, they're gonna he's not gonna be on the air. Listen,
still got the app.
Just cut the bullshit. Victor knows what it is, baby. Victor, you know
the fucking vibes.
Because this episode 180.
Yeah.
I guarantee you, by episode 200, Mike Francis is sitting right here. We're going to do this. He's on the Sucio spectrum.
That's it.
He's on the Sucio spectrum.
That's it.
All right.
You know what I'm saying?
We're going to be asking about, like, how do you feel about Artifacts, wrong side of the tracks?
Oh, yeah, man. You know who's on the wrong side of the tracks? fucking Dominicans with their bat flipping. That's the wrong side of the tracks. That's what they do. We don't do that. You got to play the game the right way. All right? Okay. I never said that. Niggas would do a podcast episode, and the next episode we'd be like, "Yo, but didn't you say?"
I never said that. Oh shit! Fuck!
Oh no!
My alert just went off.
Oh shit!
You know what time it is?
Hip hop,
yeah. Oh shit!
I need y'all. And everybody, grab your jam. Welcome to Crash. Please take your jam sport and tighten the straps.
That's right.
Tighten the straps.
Yeah.
If anyone has been graffitiing before they came to this club,
word up.
Please let us know so we can give you 5% off the drink.
That's right. If you got paint on your fingers, you get a free beer.
If you have an onk, I repeat, if you have an onk,
that's right.
Drinks are 20% off.
If you are in here with a backpack that has a graffiti book inside it,
if you free are a drinks woman all night. That believes that her pH balance is the reason why she can't orgasm, please come to the front.
That's right.
I'd like to overstand with you, queen.
You know what I'm saying?
And that's what the early 2000s were. That was a hard beat.
Hell yeah.
That was a hard beat. Oh my God. Because that was like graffiti beat. That was a writing lyrics beat. I remember, shout out to the homie G Steel. We used to sit in his, like, I was always supposed to do like a guest verse on his mixtapes. He dropped mixtapes all the time, and it would take me like 5 hours to write a verse. And I'd always ask for like one specific instrumental, and he was like, "I don't like this instrumental." I'm like, "That's not what I'm doing.
That's not what I'm doing."
Yeah. No. But the verses are fire. Like, we could actually. Rapping is not that hard if you're not stupid.
Yeah, if you have a vocabulary, you can rap. And like, exactly. Breath control, little cadence.
The vocabulary is a big thing, because when you have people like, "Yo, I got a gun, I'm with my son,
yeah,
I'm on the run," I'm like, "You really?"
All right, dog. We did that in kindergarten. Cat, yeah. Bad hat, rat.
Mm-hmm. I got the bag. I was in Baghdad. Yo, I saw a tag.
Yo. Grew up in a broken home. I'm a bad dad.
That's right. I'm an incel. I don't hang with Chads. I'm like,
okay.
I feel the flow.
Okay.
I feel the flow.
I feel the vibes.
You know what it is.
You know the fucking vibes.
You know the fucking vibes. That's when the Molly be hitting and people like, "You all right?" You be like,
"You know the fucking vibes."
Shout out to everyone that kept checking on me at Coachella when I was gone with that Molly during that Ariana Grande shit. I was like, "I'm gonna run on stage and kidnap her." They was like, "Yeah, you're not."
Yeah,
I was like, "She's very smart. I can pick her up."
Yeah.
Oh.
That would have been a moment.
What? Just me getting killed by Ariana Grande security? They'd be like, "Yo, I fuck with the show, but. Ah, it's my gallbladder, nigga. Ah!
Oh, my bad. Let me hit that one.
Ah, my hand. Nigga shot me in my hand.
Yeah, you trying to pick Ariana.
I'm saying.
Where's the other hand?
Nah. I know what you're going to do. Nah, I'm a bold hand. That's my Call of Duty hand. I'm trying to get the medals. I'm trying to lock the reactive camouflage on the guns. What's wrong with you?
Yeah.
There's a guy in jail right now, and like the big thing in his head is like, "Damn, I did not max out all my Call of Duty shit."
Yeah, he's tight.
There's probably other shit in his mind, but yeah, that. Cause when you in jail, like, you just gotta think about shit like that. Yeah. You probably think about all this. You be like, "Damn, fuck, I didn't even like. I could use all my fucking Marlboro points."
Burr.
Damn, I had that hat I didn't even wear yet.
Yo, I got that Ziploc bag full of Newport fucking points too, man.
Well, my boy went to jail, bro. Like. I didn't realize, like, it's like going to jail is a big deal. Like, what do you do with your stuff? Think about it, because you don't have money to pay rent. What happens to all your stuff?
Hope.
Yeah.
You be like, "Yo, I hope these niggas pick my shit up and take it to my mom's crib."
Yeah, but like, you can't expect your mom to have your whole apartment. Yo, that shit is crazy. Like, if you got a big sneaker collection, what happens to that?
Yeah.
Like, and he was just giving sneakers away, and I was like, "You got a bigger foot than me. I can't do shit with this shit." Shit is rough, bro. And then, like, you got to go to your management and be like, "Yo, I'm going to jail. Like, I got to break the lease."
Oh, it's a 23-hour shit. Like, "Yo, listen. Listen. Little thing happened last week.
Going to jail. Going to prison.
Go to prison. Be away for a while.
Yeah. Got a strong 7 years.
But
you know.
You know what I'm saying? But I just want to try to keep my stuff up there. Maybe don't throw it in the garbage.
And what if you're a landlord and you're like, that person had perfect, they paid like the perfect tenant up until that point. And they're like, "Can I come back and be a tenant again?" And you're like,
But you a jail nigga.
Yeah, you a jail nigga. Also, yeah, what did you go to jail for?
Let's not get into that.
Because if it was like murder or some shit like that, maybe. But if it was like tax fraud and shit, then you cool.
I went to a bar and there were sexy babies.
Oh. Oh shit, I was there. You was there too? Where was that baby?
He left for Cuba. What if Cuba was just being like a good wingman? He's like, yo, look out for my guy. My guy needs his.
Imagine we're reading the whole thing completely wrong and he was at the club with the baby.
Yeah. Well, he didn't say the baby. He said that baby.
Because he was drunk. You know when you're drunk, you slur your words and shit. He'd be like, somebody suck that baby. We gotta get the baby to clear this up.
I feel like this should be a much bigger issue than it is. The fact that this video, like, no one's ever like when do I need? We need to get to Cuba Gooding Jr. status where people just accept.
Like, yo, he's this motherfucker just wilding.
Yeah,
this motherfucker just wilding. Fuck it.
It's like
Martin Lawrence did it. Remember Martin Lawrence smoked fucking angel dust and was staying on the freeway in LA? Niggas in the, and there was helicopters all
yeah,
that?
But then he was like, he was suffering from exhaustion. Which,
that's the Hollywood term for like, nigga, I did too many, I mixed too much drugs.
Listen, when they fired me, when they fired me face down in a room in the London in LA,
I'm like, yeah, I'm exhausted.
Victor's gonna be like, he was exhausted. Victor gonna be like, they're gonna be like, he has three nostrils now. I'm like, nah, don't worry about that, bro.
Nigga got the Stevie Nicks nose and shit. Like, yo.
I was like, I'm a block away from the Phoenix. I'm a block away from the Viper Room. Call me River Phoenix. Yeah. Put me in the gutter.
Yeah.
They're like, sir, it's 4 o'clock on a Saturday.
Sir, this family's here.
No quid pro quo. No. I want nothing. I want nothing. I want nothing.
Quid pro quo. Quid pro quo.
Quid pro quo. Drain the swamp is what we're doing.
Man, fuck the election. Mega train.
So many more votes to Hillary. Yeah. Mega, we won't stop. Yeah.
Hillary died, Benghazi died. Fuck
Hillary lied, Benghazi died. Hillary lied, Benghazi died. They're going to turn this into the wire. The wild right wing meme. They're gonna play that Trump rallies and shit. What's the new diamond and silk? If they offered us, how big would the bag have? The bag would have to be bigger than what Showtime's offering us. But oof, if they came with a big enough bag, I feel like Victor would successfully land that bag. Victor would be like, please put on these wigs.
What's the price?
Let me start by saying, I believe in the universe where all things are possible. However small the possibility may be, it is technically still possible. That being said, it would have to be in the billions with a big B, because we're never going to see a check again after that.
Okay.
So I need that Jeff Bezos money.
Nigga send it to motherfucking.
Yeah. Yeah.
Nigga send it to Dennis Miller and shit. Like, yo, can't get a job nowhere, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
I don't think that's true. I think that people will continue to work with us. I think we'd be fine.
Some Tekashi said.
People would work with us and it'd be like how Ellen was hanging with Bush. People would have to do like essays about why they still hang with the Bodega Boys even though they sold out. Sometimes you have to look past their political views. They're good people.
I'd just be like, yo, I was bad high. I thought that was motherfucking, yo, I didn't know that was Vladimir Putin. He came up to him and he's
you
like,
you performed at his daughter's bar mitzvah.
Yeah, but he was like, yo.
You guys killed a prisoner for him.
Yo, but he said, I thought his name was Vlad Puta. And I know a dude on 207 that he got hoes. And he go by Blem. That's his name, Vlad Puta. He got shorties. They selling choke. I thought it was him. I fuck with him. That's my man.
This is what there's mass celebrities that do secret performances for problematic people.
Oh yeah,
you just gotta keep it on the low.
Yeah,
that's it. And that's I have no doubt Victor can pull that off.
Yo, NDAs all day. All
right, Victor's be like, yeah, we're doing a bar mitzvah for international water. I'm like, what?
I'm like, discreetly.
Speaking of bar mitzvah, your man.
Yeah. No talk.
Didn't Netanyahu get put on blast for some shit? Didn't he get like in trouble for some shit?
Yo, they got him. Yeah. What, it's bribery?
Bribery, corruption, all types
and
of
something
shit.
Like endangering the state or something. Woo, like super general, damn, but very serious.
And a breach of trust?
Breach of trust, yeah. That's what it was.
Damn.
Yeah, and it sucks because his son was talking mad spicy on Twitter. Woo. So, damn, Benjamin Netanyahu.
It's quiet for you, Manu.
Netanyahu. Yahoo used to advertise. That's what you know. Yahoo was like, yo, I got an ad. And Google was like, yeah, we work.
Yeah.
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 We don't. Have to
meanwhile, Alta Vista was like, shit, nigga.
Oh, shit.
Shit, I can't pay the rent.
Yo, maybe we pivot. Yo, no. Nah. Yo, Latino search engine, Alta Vista. Well, do you need to hear the latest Dan Ball tracks?
Hi, my name is Axe Jeeves. Let me pay your rent, so, just pull it out.
Bro,
I'll give you some search results.
Yeah, bro.
If you know what I mean by search results.
Yeah, bro. If you want some results, bro.
Yeah.
Come fuck with me, bro. Forget those guys, bro. It's Lycos.
Now, come on.
Come over here, daddy. I got that hot box for you.
Yeah.
Hot box. Yeah.
Yeah. Yo, listen. Yeah,
get your results over here.
Yo, Lycos' mouth is hot, too. My search field is really big.
Would you like to have sex with... Excite.
Excited.
Shout out to all the millennials and shit. It's like, what the fuck are they talking about? They're like,
they got a Google search engines.
That's crazy. You got a Google search engines.
Yo!
Don't Google search. If you Google search engines, you're going to make the internet flip inside out and destroy yourself. Yo, don't do it. That's like how the Matrix started.
You're going to prolapse the internet's anus if you do that. Like don't do that.
Like Ava Rose. Shout out to that veteran.
Yo, hero.
Shout out to her.
Saying? Pino hero.
All right. Shout out to our Pino heroes.
Pino first responder.
Sarah J.
You know what I'm saying?
Ava Rose. You know Marie what I mean? Love.
Mwah.
Victoria Cakes with the big ass.
Yo.
Put the cheese apart. Like,
Cherica DS.
Naomi Russell.
Yo.
Naomi
Russell was like the T-Mac of Pino.
Yo,
like,
she can't do?
Nigga, what? Hall of Famer. Then she was just like, yo, I'm off this.
That's what's crazy. That's crazy. She came through, did a Kobe-like performance, was like, yo, I'm out. Peace, nigga.
Peace.
She came through, she was like, bang, bang, hossy, anal, bang, I'm done.
I'm done, peace,
No!
And then I Googled and I Wikipedia and it was like, yo, born in Israel, this at the third, I was like, yo, did she just like stop? Like, did she just go back to Israel and
she
just stop doing pino?
She just stopped doing pino.
Oh, shit.
Like, I mean, you're allowed to stop doing pino.
Yeah,
it's just nasty niggas like us that, like you did pino 20 years ago. Wow. I can't believe you're my mortgage lawyer now.
Let's go. Shot the motherfucking Raven? Raven.
Simone?
No, not Raven Simone. Raven the Pino joint. Shit. If you look up Raven porn, she was like a very popping.
Raven porn, that's her name? Raven porn?
Not Raven porn, but just like Raven. I forgot her last name.
Raven. Okay, just Raven. Okay.
You recognize her face.
Yeah.
Yeah. She stopped doing Pino and was doing real estate for mad long and switched the whole shit over. She was like, yo, real estate. And it's her like in a blazer.
Uh-huh.
And then like years later, fucking around over there. New Raven. Like, guess the real estate shit ain't working out.
You can always fall back on the Pino.
You always fall back on Pino.
Because there's certain Pino stars that if they drop the scene right now, me and you would be like, let's fucking go. I mean, let's open the pants right now and let's fucking just put my meat on camera. Like, if Obsession dropped a new shit right now.
Yo, Caramel. Caramel. Holla.
Cara Divine.
Yo.
Cara Divine, whatever. Ooh. Nigga, I don't care if you a plumper now. I still, you know what? That's why we didn't do the timer. That's why we did not do the timer, because we are nasty niggas. Okay?
Shout out to Carmella Bing.
Woo!
Carmella Bing.
Yeah.
She went from being like, yo, thick, to being like, yo, I only do BBW Pino now.
Shit changed up.
Yeah, she switched categories.
Oh man,
Pino's foul. Pino's like the NFL. Like after yo, that's a cat. Full stop. Like it's like the NFL. After like 25, you're a MILF. I'm like, dog, that's
no. That, I think no. That's only that's in not the even Bronx. True. Shout out to Janice Griffith. She was like after 22, they be trying to put her in MILF.
In MILF shit.
I was like, the fuck. I think it's changed because back when we used to watch porn, like porn didn't come out as much as it did now.
Yeah,
now, browsers be doing like a scene a day and shit. Like back then, they used to have to make a scene, print it on DVD, ship it to stores and stuff. There was like a different life cycle. Now niggas making blueface porn.
Niggas making porno. Niggas out here making the Pino.
Okay. Out here making cream pies.
Cream pies and Pinos.
Is it blueface? Is a younger version of E40?
That could be said. know what I'm saying?
Like when E-40 first started, he sounded like Blueface. Like it wasn't
Look at the arrows on my socks.
And also, we're from New York, so I can't like knock somebody else's like.
Yeah, no, it's regional.
That's a regional shit.
Yo, and it's funny because E-40 is mad humble and mad cool guy because when.
Shout out to E-40.
Shout out to E-40, 40 Water. You know what I'm saying? Because he went on High 97 and there was an interview where they interviewed Biggie and they were like, yo, rate all these rappers on a scale of like 0 to 10.
Yeah.
And they were like, E-40, and he was like, yo, 0, that nigga's trash.
Yeah.
And then Biggie had a performance in the Bay,
mm-hmm.
and like E-40 didn't like tell them to do this, but like E-40's goons like surrounded him or whatever, yeah. and put the nigga on the phone and were like, yo, apologize to E-40.
Oh, shit.
Like, yo, and the nigga was just like, yo, he's like, yo, I got no beef with you, my nigga. Like, yo,
jeez.
Like, whatever, it's whatever. Like,
damn, Biggie's better than us, because imagine somebody surrounded us, like, we're doing a live show, so it was like, apologize.
I'll be like, yo.
I'll be like, yo.
It's like, nigga, I done seen everything but Christ, nigga.
Yo, nigga, suck my dick. The nigga I apologize to is Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. Because there's only two possibilities. They either beat the shit out of you or they kill you.
That's it.
Well, likely they're not going to kill you.
Yeah. The whole time
you can recover from any beatdown and you can come back.
Yeah.
Like, you've got punched in the face before. Nothing. You eat those.
Jumped and shit.
Jumped, stabbed, all types of shit, bro. Whatever, bro. It taught us something. We grew up in the Bronx, bro.
That's right.
That's normal shit, bro.
You know what I'm saying? I'm over here getting jumped like.
Right? I'm rolled up on the ball, niggas kicking me in the head and shit. I'm like,
yeah.
I got something for y'all niggas.
I got something for y'all niggas.
I got for y'all niggas.
Ooh, it's y'all niggas.
You just, you getting jumped and you laughing because you thinking about what you're going to do when you get back to see them niggas. The niggas is kicking you. I'm like, yeah, you done? Oh, y'all niggas done?
Ooh,
oh my God. I remember like, I was riding on the BX31. And you know how there was like on the buses, they changed the layout of the bus, but there used to be that one weird seat. That
accordion seat?
No, not this is before the accordion buses. Back when the buses just.
Oh, that one
that
seat.
That one that yeah. seat. That, and so I was yeah. sitting there, and then like this kid just punched me in the face and ran off the bus. Just a regular Bronx shit. Like at the time, I was like, what the fuck was that? And my sister saw it. And my sister was like, what the fuck happened? And I was like, he just punched me in the face and ran off the bus. And like, he thought it was some funny shit. What he didn't think was funny was the fact that my sister's boyfriend was one of the biggest hoodlums in the Bronx, and they jumped that boy and his brother, and they beat the living shit out of him. And that's why you don't punch random people in the butt, face. Because if you think about it, imagine you smashing some girl, and her little brother gets beat up. You have the ability to beat the shit out of the person that beat up her little brother.
Ooh.
You know how that's going to do for your cheek rate? Listen, he knew what he was doing. Yeah. Some kids set our garbage can on fire. The guy almost beat the kid to death. Fam, we had people terrified of my sister's boyfriends. I loved it too. I'm threatening niggas. I was like, oh, I'll call my fake brother.
Yo. Don't make me do it.
Yeah.
Don't make me fucking
he was,
do
he
it.
He was like, he was a hood nigga. Like, he was like, yo, I got something for you. And I was like, what? He was like, here. And he gave me like a magazine of guns and shit. I was like, oh shit,
mad guns.
I was like, wow, I'm just reading. I'm reading like a nighttime story. I'm like, and the 4 or 5 said, pow, 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 to the moon.
Yeah.
Good morning, Bronx. Good morning, New York.
Okay.
Good morning to you, Swine.
Good morning,
Good
Glock.
Morning, 38. Good morning, 45.
Hey.
Good morning to my Tech 9.
Hey.
I've got a pump rifle. I've got a Draco. Hello.
Hey.
How is your Safeco? Actually, that'd be good. Should we make a gun book for kids?
Yeah. Hello.
That would sell like hotcakes in America.
In the Midwest? Forget it. They eat that shit up. They have a whole fucking thing. At all those gun shows down south, they have like a whole section. We just get a set up a merch booth. Merch booth. Good night, Glock.
It's nighttime. Take your guns. Run. There comes a liberal. He's trying to take your guns.
Oh, no.
Oh, no. He's under the bed.
Oh.
Look at
that
liberal.
Shoot that libtard in the head.
We're sovereign citizens. Oh. We don't respect feds. Are we at enough money to become Republican yet?
Not yet.
Can't wait.
Gotta wait a couple months.
I can't wait, and I just it's gonna be great.
Like, listen, you gotta reach across the aisle.
Mm-hmm.
That's gonna be my first tweet when I'm like,
I'm gonna be like Stephen A.
Smith. Gotta reach across the aisle.
I'm like, yo, why Colin Kaepernick? You know, does he want to play in the NFL? Is he just being egregious? It's ridiculous. Okay,
Matt, kill him and fight it on my show.
If Colin Kaepernick wants to play in the NFL, he can't kneel. You can't catch the ball kneeling. That's just ridiculous.
I mean,
my hot take.
He's like, he's a quarterback. He don't catch the ball.
You are okay.
So I'm a side quarterback that kneels? That's how you end the game.
Huh?
Please explain to me how that benefits black people.
That's how you run out the clock.
Okay?
And we, as black people, we running out the clock.
We always run out the clock. That's why we buy watches. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Okay? My rollie don't take it talks.
That's right.
Okay?
It's bust down.
Jason Whitlock's like, He's right. Now back after these messages, I'm talking about how to make the softest baby back ribs. Okay, ooh, we'll be right back.
I'll be right back.
I'm cooking ribs underneath my hat.
I think he's in the studio with a deep fryer for making deep fried Oreos.
The makeup lady comes over to do touch-ups, but it's just gravy. Jason, did you lick off your mutton again?
Aww. He's like, you know I did.
You know every now and then he tries to eat the guest. Well, you're gonna tell me, so a pork pie hot is not made of pork pie? Pork?
I'll be the judge of that.
This is egregious. It's like eating Max Kellerman's hat. Whitlock slender.
Yeah, I love it. Yeah.
I bless the rays down in Africa. Did we sing that song last night? No,
she's like no.
That's like it was a blur. Like, I don't remember either. I do not remember either. All I know is at some point someone was like, "Deez, you going to the karaoke party?" And I was like, "Nah." And Victor was like, "Yeah, you are." And I was like, "All right, I guess we are." And I was trying to be chill. I was like, "All right." I was do my little two-step.
Try to be chill. He said like 4 or 5 songs. And don't make me name some of those.
Don't sleep.
We're going to leave it at creep. And that's it.
Radiohead creep. Ariana Grande breathe. Okay.
Strong choices.
So listen, I've seen the fuck out Ariana Grande breathe.
Yeah.
I don't need the lyrics.
Just keep breathing and breathing and breathing.
Everyone was like, they were like, yeah, your eyes are closed. I was like, I'm feeling it. Oh, and Shallow. Shout out to Z-Wave.
Hold up. So
we did a very black version of Shallow that has replaced the Lady Gaga version.
It was very erotic. When you sang Breathe, did you know, and it goes, breathing and breathing and breathing and breathing.
You mean the best part?
And then it goes,
oh, the high note? Yeah, you know I hit that high note. Yeah.
Like, what did she say? Was she...
You know, I can't keep up.
I'm like, what?
You know, get something, keep on breathing. Woo. Feel my body. And you got me to the time.
Yo, I want to. That's good that you mentioned Ariana Grande.
You say that queen's name properly.
Ariana Grande, because I want to segue into this. Your ponytail's too tight.
You know what? You know what?
You're gonna crack your hairline.
You know what?
You're gonna crack your hairline. No, I had an ex. My ex did it, and she cracked her hairline. I don't want that to happen to you. You got a lot of years ahead of you.
You really think Ariana Grande doesn't have like a million hairdressers working with her? And she, no, she's just some dirty broad from the Third Avenue. She has to worry about cracking her hairline. Ariana Grande has never uttered the phrase, "I'm worried about my hairline cracking." Do you think she goes to host them? You think she's like trying to get her life better? She's a multi-millionaire.
She got to hit the baby hairs with the toothbrush in the morning, nigga, with the LA looks, nigga, mega hole. Like, yo.
That's the most wash shit you ever did. You know, get Ariana, yeah, listen, young girl, you're doing good, but don't crack your hairline. I've seen it happen before. Happened to this girl. I remember I went to school with this girl. She used to ride the 6 train. She was a dancer.
Yeah.
Her name was Jennifer. Guess what her last name was?
Yeah.
Lopez. Yeah. I knew her.
Look at where she is now. Her hairline's cracked.
Yeah. I blew her back out once at a cup party.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was lit.
It was lit.
We were smoking mango pina.
It was wild. Fat Joe was there. Ruben Diaz was there before it was the mayor. He brought some whack weed. She was trash.
What do you think he's doing with a record? Oh, shit. Like, yo. He's like, yo, guys, I got a tray bag.
Oh, here comes Ruben.
Oh,
here comes this political asshole. Shit was wild because then Mike Bloomberg came through and, like, he had a sweater on.
Yo! And Bloomberg and the only nigga come through with yay?
Mike Bloomberg came through with yay, but he wouldn't share. Hate to see it.
He's like, it's my yay.
He was like, ¿Cómo te llamas? No. It's my coquina.
Hey, can I ask you a question? Why doesn't your refrigerator dispense ice?
It's the Bronx, Mike.
I'm going to go to the bodega.
I'm going to go to La Tienda. Anyone want anything?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you necesitas us algo?
He came to the party with his combos.
Like, 2 little combos and his beer. He can put his ice in his beer.
I got these at the Port Authority, bro.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Enjoy. They let me keep them for free.
I don't want to spoil you guys, but here.
Peppermint Mentos.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Don't put those in your Coca-Cola.
Excuse me.
Oh.
Yo.
Still draining being on the Sucio spectrum.
Oh my God.
People don't understand. Like, we could, the same way Kanye does this fucking church shit, we just do Sucio spectrum all over the country.
Yo.
Because we have this break between until February 3rd, we can just scam the world.
Yo.
And just do mad like concerts and shit. Is there, has any place had like an earthquake or a huge tragedy recently?
Well, we can make one happen.
There's mass civil unrest in Chile and shit.
Wait, hold on. Okay, the brand is that strong?
Who's the fucking, who's the governor of Minnesota that used to be a wrestler that he was like, yo, the government is.
Jesse Ventura.
Yeah, Jesse Ventura.
You and Jesse Ventura about to get heart popping?
You know what I'm going to do during this break? I'm going to watch all of it. He's a UFO truther.
Yeah.
And with all this, yo, I'm going to watch all his conspiracy theories. I'll be like a little high late at night, like, oh shit.
Well, remember, he said that
the tsunami, I'm looking out my window.
He said the tsunami happened because the U.S. government
made it happen.
Planted landmines or put a exploded a bomb by one of the faults underneath the Pacific Ocean. So should we do that again?
Uncle Maybe. Jesse.
I just imagine Victor and Diana.
That's a very
Victor
different type Diane of Uncle Jesse.
They're just like swimming to the bottom of the ocean, yeah. Planted. To like, CB's like, plant that damn charge.
Plant the fucking charge now. She's in like a room with just like green light.
Yeah.
She, like run for Red October. She's like, plant the fucking bomb now. She's like, Diana, swim faster. She's like, CB, I'm swimming as fast as I can. She got a hard drive with the podcast on it and shit. She's like, no snorkel, nigga, no nothing. No tank and shit. She's just like,
You know, I'm texting her. I'm like, can I get a BLT and coffee? Thank you.
She just come up out the water with the BLT and the coffee and the bomb and detonated and all that shit. Like, yo, I did it. Yo.
Oh man.
Oh shit. Oh.
I did it.
Yeah.
Ah, that's crazy.
Success.
Success. That's what we. That's what we're suffering from. Success. Oh God. That's why.
That's right.
I'm saying, you boys, the Bodega Boys. These are nice.
That's right.
Kid, I was called the Kid Chipotle. I have no idea.
The Kid Chipotle.
But it's been episode 180.
Yeah, motherfucker.
Named after East 180th, which is one of the best train stations. Could you transfer from the 2 to the 5.
That's right.
Shout out to the. And then sometimes, if you're lucky, the 2 train goes express.
That's right.
The 5. And they're like, bing bong, next bing stop, bong. East 149th Street. And you're like, also, yeah. But if you live in between East 149th Street and 180th, you're like, fuck.
Yo,
I live on Jackson. Damn, what am I doing
what
now?
The fuck, bro? Ah. Fuck. Damn.
Also, but everyone knows the women with the best pussy in New York City live on either Jackson Ave or anywhere between 149th Street and 180th on the Bronx, on the 2 train. I'm sorry. It's true.
Fire Choach, Intervale.
If she lives on a whole avenue, that shit fire. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. I swear by that, bro.
I swear by that, bro. I mean, listen.
Listen, I was talking to Corey Guns the other day. He agreed with me.
It's a lived experience.
Yo, it's your boy, Jesus Nice, a.k.a. Young Chipotle, a.k.a. Pockets Stay Fat Like Tyrio, a.k.a. Pockets Stay Fat Like, here we go!
Hey!
Slow it down, I know you, but Young Day Parties, Young Hot Take, DJ Fuego, Mr. Nando's with a Rondo. Ooh. Get a little peri peri sauce, you know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Nasty. Mil 1924 and 4 in the world of York. Mikhail going off the Juve, boss MC, yeah. Put up from 40, which is shorty. Ooh. AKA don't talk to me in the Uber pool, because I don't know you. Matter of fact, if I'm in an Uber pool, that means I'm super drunk and I ordered the wrong Uber.
That's right.
Because why would I be in an Uber pool?
Why?
Okay.
Why do that?
I don't get in pools.
You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
You know
what
Uber pool leads to?
Mm-hmm. There you go. Only pools I swim in is the one Kendrick raps.
That's right.
Because that's hip-hop.
Yeah.
Real hip-hop.
Real hip-hop. I love
it. I am a robot.
I like books.
The original why plus one got plus ones will make a fuss. You know what? I realized just that I didn't even have a plus one. I was even on, there was a list. I wasn't on it. Like, and I checked it, and they was like, yeah, you don't have to check it. It's your fucking party. And I was like, oh. That's not as much fun. Shit. Don't make a fuss, son.
Yeah.
Like, I like to just grab random people on the street and be like, yeah, you're coming with me. Books.
Come on, let's go.
Make it stressful. I like to see people at the door stressed. Because, like, say, like, I'm like, I'm coming dolo, and I come with like five people. Mm. Like now you have some person that's just working a regular job, and now they have to tell me, a big celebrity, my crew can't come in. Mm. And you just see them panic because they're like, I need this job.
Oh, God, fuck.
I actually never do that, but I'm just saying.
I was about to say,
just
like,
a warning for the future.
Chanel Jesus Coast. Like, this shit ain't even popping.
This shit ain't even popping. I was on Wildin' Out Season 7.
That's right.
Okay.
I could rap.
I was on the episode with Maya Angelou.
That's not Little Pump.
Dizzy Rossi is a Jamaican Jew. Jermaine Avocado Toast. That's right. I'm $21 in LA. Young Pa, the Goose of Mufasa. Samurai for me, my nigga. Yo, Shakuni without the coonery. Yeah, y'all. AKA Chili Lamone, left handed reliever for the Yankees. K-Lo, K. Oh, listen, Bobby. Spring training is coming in. By spring training, I mean, I got to get myself a chape.
Hey, Bobby, Lola.
3-4 Jones. DJ Machina. G Chuckles. Stanley Cups. The Herman Dr. Bonner's label. Dilute.
Three times.
Also, shout out to Dr. Bonner's, which you can use to clean your beard, or clean your car, or clean your vagina.
That's
right. I don't understand how that works, but you know,
it clean everything.
Clean everything. Deonato the Trapio, Mr. 240p, because I like my pino blurry. Yeah.
Ow, 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 ow.
I like to go in the comments and be like, who's this? And someone responds, she died. Hey!
Yeah. That makes it even hotter.
Yeah, it's even hotter. It's like jacking into a ghost, bro. Wow.
Shout out to all my niggas out there still fucking.
You ever beat your meet the Casper, the friendly ghost? Same thing, bro. Same thing. She can watch from heaven.
Bro, the funny thing is that I had like three names on deck, too.
I have like four. And you know, because you'd be like, damn, that's sad.
So these are vintage now. These are like vintage classics.
Yeah. That's that all that. Look at Victor. He's like, oh, they're throwing the bag away. They're throwing the bag away.
I'm ashamed I only had one.
Sucio special. Wait a minute. Holy shit. I just realized something. We've been thinking about doing the Sucio Spectrum forever because on that last show, we had a rainbow. The Sucio Spectrum symbol is going to be the rainbow. Wow. We're bringing it back.
Hold that.
Because that's the Milk Studios. Like, isn't there?
Yeah.
And we're going to continue the legacy of Milk.
Right.
So, yes.
Boom. Sucio Spectrum.
Harvey Milk.
Wow. Boom. Double
Sucio
S.
Spectrum. Wow. Listen.
Wow.
Yeah. We're going to go down to history as, like, the greatest allies. And everyone that was alive was like, no.
No.
They were not. No, they were not.
They were just like, talking about fucking porn.
Listen to their podcast.
It's like, porn.
They recognize people, but they don't recognize them.
It's going to be like an episode of Twilight Zone where everybody had the pig face. So and like, then there was the one lady with the regular
ugly
face.
She's ugly.
She's like, you don't understand what's going on. I'm beautiful. You guys are ugly.
Shut
you
up.
Look like pigs.
You come over here, you pig face, bitch. Yeah. Actually, and this is how I'm going to let you guys know how freaky I am. There's actually an object you can buy for during sex, and it pulls people's noses back like that.
It's like to make them look like pigs?
Like a pig nose device.
That is wild.
Yeah. No one knows about this? The pig snout?
Pig snout? I mean, I see wild shit. I seen some like weird like ball gags and shit. And well, we did the fucking escape room, bro. They had the wild fucking sex dungeon.
Yeah, they got it's like a metal thing. I don't see it on this. I forgot where they sell it, but basically it like hooks your nose like this back.
Yo.
Yeah, it's like, listen.
The glop, glop was consensual. Yeah.
I don't even know. God.
You know the vibe.
DJ Woolite. AKA.
You know the fucking vibe.
You know the fucking vibe.
Like, glop, glop, glop.
Wow, wow,
wow. Yeah. Glop, glop, glop.
We're gonna add that to the soundboard next week. As we continue to just be like the most problematic website ever.
Shorty, with that enthusiastic topic though, boy.
Enthusiastic topic.
Yeah, like the glop, 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 glop. Shorty, don't sound like a cat coughing up a hairball. Yeah.
Woo. DJ Wolf, I can't listen to Wash FM. Because I haven't been bringing the Wash FM heat. I'm taking it back.
Take it back. Take it
to
back.
Real hip hop. You guys remember ADOR? Let it all hang out. Don't this sound like some hip hop shit?
Oh my God.
People forget. Was he Spanish? He looks like Mero's brother. Yeah, that's
this is when everybody in the rap in the background was going this.
That's right. Yeah, the rap horns. The Hasan. Like that. Yo, the car we go. DJ Spice, Jamal Hasbro, and the Bronx, Celine Dion, Ray and Nephews.
Nephews.
The Marino, you cannot contain all the human memory. What's a job? Young Aaron, where he's a provocateur. Henrik Budkrauz, Nelson Mandela, Sergio Cassini, Vladimir
Buffy.
The human world is melting in your mouth. Mr. Bexon Decanton, Ricky Ticky Squabby, Greg Popovich, Morris Dance with your chestnut. Mahatma Gandhi, not Maggie Bieber, that cucumber.
Yeah.
The juice of press, but your boy never is. Ooh, I am the art damn. The Dungada Ganoush. No more cover news. The Prince of Pecker. Fashion over casting over. The we make 75 cents, 10 cents, dollars. Get the small change. Give me.
Where you are? Where you need? Where you are?
Big money. Dolly anthem. I salute. Dip set. Sack of cashmere. Square one. Top left. Mantis. Mar.
Yo,
true. Rizzuto. Holy cow. Mr. Alfonso. All I'll do is count checks and jerk off. That's right. Yeah. I'll be stroking my meat. Making that sweet jerking. Sweet stroking all. Hey. We got OJ. Purple Soap Soda. And it's me. Sunny D. Hey. I'm in the back of your fridge. David, you're, I mean, these expensive, these are red bottles, these are bloody shoes. Smokeem, Noah, Andrew Coonan, aka the Junior Energy God Junior. Come sit down, pardon me.
Sit, pardon, sit, pardon, sit, pardon. Why, pardon, charger?
Come and Petco, because I got your bitch on freeze. And they're like, no, that's not how you pronounce that's it. I said, I got your bitch on freeze.
Nah, shut up.
Come pick up your dog.
That's it. There's a new name for it. That's it.
The top of gossip and Syosset. That's right. Shout out to the 11791. You know what it is. It's not even Rangerstown over here. It's Islanders, bro.
That's right, bro.
AKA Grandpa Joe, because when you see Charlie, you see me, don't touch that golden ticket, you might get cut. Your man dead IDs is morning, Sheriff. The shot man Street Easy bad beats to come easy. Please believe me. Shout out to Street Easy. The black Asian addict will crack your back like an automatic craft magic. The whole point of Street Easy is using it not to buy anything, just to know what part of New York you're in. Because you open it, and you're like, what the? This is Yorkville? What the fuck is Yorkville?
What is the Yorkville?
Yorkville's like 72nd Street.
What is that?
There's places in New York, they have names for the community that as a poor, we don't know them.
Yeah. You're like, what do you live? Oh, I live in Murray Hill.
I'm like, what?
What is that?
I live in the Olive Garden section of New York. I'm like,
excuse me?
What? Yeah, you turn left on 2nd Avenue and you make a left on the Hospitaliano Broad.
What the fuck? What? Nigga, that shit don't exist.
They're lying to us, bro. They're lying. The black idiotic crack your back like automatic craft, man.
Yeah.
Mr. La Marina in a mesh. Mr. Mina with a fresh Mr. Mina and a cold demeanor. Hey. I gotta play the guitar. Team Mass Killer, Illa. No one could be Illa. The black Zach Morris, support Morris. Young KPI God for damn. My marketing people. Next second best, put me to the test.
Yeah.
Things on your chest. You need to confess. I will deliver. You know I am forgiven. Yeah. Your own personal Jesus. Shout out to the peace.
Oh, shit.
AKA the problematic bae. Listen, it's not your problem. It's not your secret family. Put them in the trunk and drive into a lake.
Right. Shit, goddamn.
Also, you have to blame it on two black guys.
Yo.
Y'all remember who I'm talking about, right?
Yeah, Casey Anthony the God.
No, not Casey Anthony. Lady,
who was it?
Two black guys, Carlick. The lady that...
Is that like the default, like I killed my kids?
Susan Smith.
Oh, wow.
You guys remember Susan
Casey
Smith?
Casey Anthony said the same shit? Wow.
No, this is it. Casey Anthony allegedly might have killed her child. They can't prove that they did. They found the evidence and the thing, but they don't have evidence that that's where she got.
That's what she beat
the body. But in South Carolina, Susan Smith, I guess she had like post-traumatic stress syndrome or something, or she just hated her kids. She put their kids in a lake, put them on a ramp, put the car in neutral, and let the car drive into the lake. The kids died. She told the cops two black guys carjacked her, stole the car, and did that. And then the cops found out after, you know, she said a black guy did it. And easy, they was like, nah, that's not true. She actually did she go to jail for it, I believe?
She's like, no. She's
yeah, like, she did go to jail.
She's like general manager at Applebee's and shit.
Nah, she was like, you just got to apologize in court.
I'm sorry, I killed my kids, my fault. Yo,
they was like, what about the black guy? Sorry. She was like, you bring up bullshit. Did that problematic, right?
Yeah. Yo,
quid pro quo.
Guess what, motherfuckers?
You know the fucking vibes.
You know the motherfucking vibes.
Saying? It's your boy, the camera, aka the human durag flap, aka Donovan McDab. You know what I'm saying? Aka Curve Gotti, aka Triz Khalifa.
Hey, skirt loader, drop the fuck, motherfucker, hop the curb. Hit your Italian greyhound to keep it moving, nigga. Ask me if I give a fuck. I do not. I know fucking baby, I'm fucking Ming, my nigga. You know what I'm saying? AKA, no need to check the guest list. I am the guest list, nigga. I play drunk David Hasselhoff in the David Hasselhoff story on the Hallmark Channel. Don't fucking touch me, nigga.
I saw that. I saw it. Was really good. You did a really good job. You know what I'm saying? Why was it filmed in DR?
Because we had to get David Hasselhoff like drunk.
Oh, okay.
You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? And, you know, we had a limited liquor budget. Gotcha. You know what I'm saying? AKA CC Dabath here. You know what I'm saying? AKA James St. Fatic. I'll go so you shorty. And I'm going to find out who killed me. AKA Tiger Backwoods. Smoke a three. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to smoke a 3 grand backward. And then hit you with this motherfucking 9 iron nigga. AKA get into the shmoney and the smoke. It's your boy Goldman Schmatch. You know what I'm saying? AKA I got all my kids in the Peck Eye School of Business. Because I'm the motherfucking dad of the year. You know what I'm saying? AKA
y'all niggas need to put your mind together and make some fucking money.
That's right. Y'all niggas is lacking. Yo, Bodega Princess, you 2 years old. You should be making mad money right now.
Gat Google?
Yo, listen to me. Get out there and fucking put in some work. You understand what I'm saying? If you don't come back here with $10,000 and a new corporation, I'm gonna smack the shit out of you. Let's go. Love y'all niggas, man. Y'all my brothers. AKA Bitch Smack Me Up, AKA Diego Maradona, AKA Dick and your baby on top of. You don't come with this pussy no more. This pussy belong to me. You know what? I changed my mind. I've reformed. This pussy belongs to us, and I respect our agency. Therefore, aww, if you wish to engage and court us with me, we please must agree on this. Thank you. I am a true ally. AKA David Trisdell, pow, you know what I'm saying? I'm about to get fired at this bitch. You know what I'm saying? Take that for data, nigga. You
wait, the next play tonight?
Huh?
The next play tonight?
Oh, you know it, baby. Oh. It's Friday. Baby, little
and brown, brown, brown. I don't fuck.
I gotta get
this. I'm about to call Domino's. I'm like, nigga, get those hot wings on deck.
Fast as I can.
You know, Nick fans, we're sad. I get so excited about Nick games.
Yeah.
Sad,
I get excited
bro.
About next game just to watch RJ Barrett play. I'm not even gonna lie.
Yeah.
Just to watch him play.
Now I'll be having the wings. I might throw on a jersey, smoke my little weed, got my Becks. I'll be standing up when they score.
Fam. I did the thing where I got all the kids' jerseys, and I got them all Yankees jerseys. Mm-hmm. I got them all Giants jerseys. I got them all Knicks jerseys. And Mero Jr. was like, yo, I want Melo. And I was like, Melo don't play for the Knicks no more. He's like, nah, I want Melo. I want a Melo Knicks jersey. I was like, well, I was like, shit, nigga, you just saved me like fucking $40. He's like, I got this shit for like $7 at motels.
Oh, shit. Yo, Knicks versus Nets on the Sunday.
Oh, shit.
At MSG. You know that's going to be a...
Oh, it's going to be a shit
that's
show.
Gonna be, that's going to be an ugly one. I might have to be in attendance for that.
Imagine the Nets on those courtside tickets. Like, yo, here.
For the Knicks game?
Oh, Jesus.
How did you get here? Nobody's supposed to be here. And you know I'm not playing the regular version. I'm doing the Walk Club remix. Like,
the Poppers remix?
Oh.
Yo. Shout out to Deborah Cox for a headline. No, Bronx
Hex
Pride.
Hector. The Hex Hector remix.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Listen, that's, here we go. That's how it works, bro.
Let it rock. Let it rock.
Y'all know what it is. You in the sound factory?
Oh, shit.
You hear this shit?
Oh, shit.
This man, this is a receptionist right now. Listen to WKTU. Woo! Ignore this man following.
Yo, let me tell you something. Yo, your titty sucked a dick in a bathroom to this.
Time. How did you get here?
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Pasha.
I'm just like, I'll take off my shirt. I got mad clothes. Yeah. I got a whistle. I'm like, like some white girl called me N-word. I'm like, whoa, what the fuck is going on?
My father runs a construction company in South Jersey. You want to come home?
I'm like, blow your voice,
yeah. Let's go.
She's like, you had it in the trunk.
You go first.
I'm like, what time is it? She's like, 3 p.m. I'm like, that's not, how is it 3 p.m.
How?
And we're in a nightclub?
How?
And you open the door and the sun's like, yeah,
oh, it is 3 p.m. Oh, shit, nigga, it's 3 p.m. Goddamn.
I'm like, is that a baby in a carriage? What the fuck? And shout out to Pasha. You were leaving there. Was like, yo, whoa, big man.
here's a lollipop. I was like, what the fuck do I need a lollipop for? And I realized I'm on mad fucking ecstasy. I'm like,
that's why dogs here look like a fucking fool.
I'm like, I can't find my car, but I can simply walk home to the Bronx. Niggas just walking on the FDR. Go around.
I need the white stone. Yo, Barlow's antenna so smooth. I fall asleep at the wheel and crash a zip car. You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean? AKA the Dominican Dandana Dagman Daddy. You know what I'm saying? Catch me at some motherfucking hookah spot that don't even got a sign on it. And I'm in there with two bitches with cat suits. Cash only.
Why? For some people, that sounds like a worst time. And low-key, I'm like, what's the address? Listen, all I need is from a stripper is just wear those fake cat ears.
Oh,
I'm like,
yeah. Yo, drop a pin, man.
Say less. Say less.
Yo, AKA swipe my motherfucking card again. There's definitely money on there. They don't want to make me embarrass you in front of your management when they come up here and ask for quick selfies and ask me how Heather the kids is doing, stupid. You like your little fucking target job, Edward? Huh? Put the motherfucking throw pillow in the back and keep it moving, nigga. Stop playing with me, yo. You know what I'm saying? AKA. Tu favorito, mami. Romeo Santos. So zanny. Let me black out. Wow. What happened yesterday? Oh, my God. I was in United Palace with my dick out? Oh, my God. Take the pictures now. AKA. Light Nail Duchy. Hello? Is it weed you're looking for? I can see it in your eyes.
In your eyes.
That you're broke ass ain't got fun. You know what I'm saying? We doing 20s or better now, B. Come on, man. We uptown, bro. Stop playing. Ain't no nickel bags uptown. Get the fuck out of here, bro. Fuck out of here. Trade bag days is over, nigga. Shit.
The trade bags is over. The trade bags is over. So run for your nickels. Run for your dimes. And run for your marijuana in the high tech. Nigga, the field is a weed on behind. You got marijuana and you cannot smoke mine. The weed bags is over. Yeah. Sorry.
AKA Tom Brazy, you know what I'm saying? Your girl got my balls deflated, you know what I'm saying? Me and Bobby Kraft, we were the table shower boys, you know what I mean? Yeah. AKA Field to Ass Tyson, I want to explore your cosmos, man. Consensually, you know what I'm saying?
Consensually.
AKA, you know what I mean? Little snoozy vert, first nigga to fall asleep, tapping out on the Instagram live, you know what I mean? First nigga to ever do it, innovator, you know what I'm saying? The originator like Jazzo, you know what I mean? No greater. AKA Final Messi, MVP of Gelato. You know what I'm saying? AKA Zaniel Bettyfield. I gotta get some sticks. You know what I'm saying? AKA Joe Hooker. I dare you to smoke with me at Mama Sushi. You know what I'm saying? Like a flagship, nigga. Well, it's not official.
I don't even think they call themselves flagship. They're like, no, that's our first store.
It was just the first joint.
You call me flagship?
What?
What that mean?
What that mean, Papi?
What that mean, Papi?
No. You trying to play me, my nigga. Nah, I don't like that shit, bro. I'll fuck you up, my nigga. Fuck out of here.
I know ship.
Nah. You see what I did in my mini bang right there on the strip, my nigga. Don't play with me.
AKA Ben Boston. My hands are gifted. Have you ever reconstructed an athletic child's spinal cord using only stickers from the dentist? Hmm? You haven't. Get on my level, nigga.
Get on my level.
That's right. Sing it to him. Say it louder for the niggas in the back.
Everybody.
Yeah.
Get on Ben's level. Get on Ben's level.
Can't get the strap. Let me see that chocolate, that Hershey Kiss nibble, baby.
You know what I'm saying? AKA, open your motherfucking medicine cabinet. You know who the fuck it is, boy. It's the Zen Man. AKA, Rico Sabroso. AKA, Baby Newport, 2 for $5. Niggas got garbage down the way. You know what I'm saying? My shit ain't stank. They from Delaware. I got them from Uncle Joe. You know what I'm saying? AKA, Nino Brown, shut the car down. You know what I'm saying? AKA, live roaming Section 5 in Co-op City. It's the East Stream on Stevie B doing all his greatest hits like,
I wanna be the one your DD is fucking. And don't take love. Don't let me lean.
You know what I'm saying? Because you nigga lean and get hit by the 9 bus, bro. What's
up? Poppy, you're too near the curb. Poppy, come on.
Don't stop.
Stevie, get away from the curb. You're going to fall in front of the bus. Oh, you're going to get hit by the BX-12.
Oh, but it's okay, Poppy. I got my metro cars. Go.
No, you come on.
No, Poppy.
I know you used to sing, but now you're going to fall.
Oh my god.
Hit those high notes for me, Poppy.
Oh, it doesn't look. I wanna be one.
Yeah. He's a good guy. He's a good guy. He gave my aunt AIDS, but he's good.
I love you, baby.
He just said he gave my aunt AIDS. Got you.
Yo, son. Listen, mate. Listen, let me tell you something, mate. When you hear content like that, it's only produced by the last two rock stars on earth, mate.
Goddamn right. Goddamn right.
You never get content like this anywhere else on the fucking planet. You know? And you're getting it for niche.
For niche.
For niche.
For Zed.
For Zed. For less than you would pay to pick and mix, mate. You know what I'm saying?
Can't find this at Audie's, mate.
No.
No.
No. This, we got the sauce like Nando's.
Exactly, the peri-peri. The
peri-peri sauce. Okay. That's right. You know what I'm saying? The Bodega Boys, of which I am one. The plantain supernova in the sky. One day you will find me smoking weed on Tremont with some choppies out here on the strip of smoking hooks. You know what I'm saying? Sorry. And Bill flipping the coal. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to him.
Shout out,
saying?
My nigga. Shout out, my nigga.
No.
Shout out.
AKA, I met Mike Francis. I'm never going to fail. You know what I'm saying? Because he's, you know what I mean? He told me I run faster first.
Oh, bro. You know what I'm saying? Brother, this guy stinks.
AKA, yo, fuck KD and Kyrie. We in Portland smoking legal. It's Barmelo's Anthony.
You know the fucking vibes.
That's right. You know what I'm saying? Yo, if you see me at Target higher than the motherfucking Hubble telescope holding two rockets, approach me like a motherfucking Earth-sized mammal, nigga, because I'm in the dialing section and I'm acting erratic. You know what I'm saying?
Cause you will attack and you won't like that.
You know what I'm saying? AKA, hey kids, it's Benzo the Clown. Hire me for your kid's birthday party. I'll show up before. Is it today or tomorrow? Who cares? But here's Mr. Fun Fun. Can I get my cash now, please? my arms itch.
Hey kids, we're going to do some karaoke. I'm going to creep. I'm a weirdo. What the hell am I doing here? I don't belong here. Legally, I don't belong here because I have to tell you guys that I'm a sex offender. I don't care if it hurts.
Yeah, you're hugging her a little too.
I want to have control.
Oh, wow. Okay.
I want a perfect body.
All right. Time to go, guys. Okay, all right. All right. AKA, I sold fake lead to your favorite SoundCloud rapper. He's high of hand sanitizer and peach Snapple I found in my garage on the floor, nigga.
I think we actually broke the milk room. I think the milk room itself was like, y'all niggas is wildin'.
Y'all wildin'. Y'all need to chill.
The goose, the milk. Ooh. People don't realize a lot of people were killed down here using milk.
That's right.
That's what...
You know what I'm saying? Jamroom. They got water. They got milk boarded to death.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
It was like, oh, they was like, oh, you don't want to talk? You want to talk? Here's some half and half.
Imagine, damn, you drowning and getting bubble guts at the same time.
Damn. Yeah. But then you know, like, you're like, I'm gonna die, bro. I'm gonna take a wild shit before I die. So that joke's on you.
Fuck y'all.
You're gonna choke.
Yeah, I have to clean this whole shit up.
Yeah.
Yeah. Stupid.
It's running down my ankle.
Yeah!
Everyone's at your open casket like, pee you!
This nigga died doing what he loved. Eating beans.
Eating beans. This nigga eating beans! Papi, you know what time it is, coño! Hasan, dime, repito, yo que lo que. Llegó el hijo de FIFA, coño. Me invitó la igualita a una panadera, Guaremate, que hace más pa 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 que el diablo, coño! You know what I'm saying? Siempre con una pinta nueva y la cartera llena, llégale a la grasa, coño, como huevo. Yo soy un chichi, yo toco todo. You know what I'm saying? AKA, fuck that shit. Shout out a la casa, Showtime, shout out Hasan y Senga que ponen la fucking nota. You know what I'm saying? Shout out Desus Bueno, you know what I'm saying? Shout out Justin Marqueta in the motherfucking building. You know what I'm saying? Victor Hugo, el matatán, el cerebro, el motherfucking Death Star con coconut oil. You know what I'm saying? Y, como siempre, shout out a la nena de la bodega, Dai y Vicky, que está inválida la pobrecita, pero la estamos chequeando. You know what I'm saying? Shout out to my nigga right here. Down in South Bronx in the house, you know what I'm saying? One time for you, man. Sucio medicine in the motherfucking building, nigga. What's up?
Yeah,
he's doing it. Perico Limited. If you don't buy the shit, you you're not for the who, baby.
You know what I'm saying? There you go.
Y shout out to President Pío, Secretario de Defensa, activo con el cañón sobao. Tú me avisas, mi loco, que lo suelto.
We die for you, Pío.
That's right. Pronto libertad, mi hermano friki. Me quité. Ya, peace. Episode 180.
Pío is the war minister for the socio spectrum.
That's right.
Yo, shout out to everyone that fuck with the show. Thank you for allowing us to have season one on Showtime.
That's right. Because
you know, there were some haters that said that no one would follow us on Showtime. How they feel now?
They feel like...
But we're not recognizing the haters. Yeah. We're recognizing the positive. We'll be back February 3rd on Showtime, the most illustrious show in the world. And guess what? This free fucking podcast, Stay Free, still comes to you live from the Jam Studios. You know what it is? Cash App still holding us down. You know what I'm saying? You see us. You know what it is. Victor, Diane, Justin, Hasan, we out here. You know what it is? The most illustrious podcast in the fucking world. You know the fucking vibe. Episode 180, we out. Ah, holla.